Events of the past and the future. Hi, I'm Larry Bensky with you every Sunday morning from 9 to 11. We have interesting guests and we have you, the listeners, phoning us in abundance. It's a different way to wake up your body and hopefully your mind as well. 9 to 11 a.m. every Sunday morning here on KPFA 94.1 FM. Please join us.
Broadcasting around the galaxy, around the clock. We'll be saying a big hello to all intelligent life forms everywhere and to everyone else out there. The secret is to bang the rocks together, guys.
Please,
what does this mean?
Scan image of security.
Immortality. The cherished moments of your life will now live on forever. All that you hear with your ears will be preserved so that it can be experienced by loved ones you leave behind.
Honestly, security
and that's
scan
what great
progress.
Memories are made of. From our family
don't
to yours.
Please. Image locked.
Retinal scan imaging for access.
Identity match.
RSI system engaged. Scanning.
Granted. synthesizers, who depend on us to tell their messages to the largest possible number of persons, we make every effort to please most of the people most of the time. This is the reason we play popular music, plus gold records that were purchased by a million or more persons. In the case of controversial records, such as Judy May, we do not air these records at all until listener request demands it. As in this case, often the Nashville stations, who are our competitors for listeners, give heavy airplay to these records, causing our listeners to continually call for them. And in order to keep our listeners from leaving Murfreesboro Radio to go to Nashville Radio, we allow limited play, meaning only when requested, and not more than once on each announcer's shift. We do not, and we will never, endorse or promote bad recordings. We will always make every effort to bring you the best radio it is possible for us to produce. We are not perfect. There is only one who was. As far as we know at this time, this record has not been protested anywhere else in the country. And it is Murfreesboro's chance today to cast the first stone.
We'll take your calls right now at 893-5373. Taking calls right now at 893-5373. Tell us what you think of this record by Boomer Castleman.
As an only child, 17, it hurt when my mom and dad, but when my daddy got lost, a few days later, he really couldn't write down a cry. But after a year, he up and wed a girl that was half his age. Then the family was my daddy and me. Judy May.
Reynolds. Ronald Reynolds cannot record. Ronald Reynolds cannot record any good man. You want to record. You call any act. You don't know Ronald. Ronald is a bad recorder. That's why he's looking at my guy every day. Everyone.
You want to be Rachel.
Ah! go ahead and use some of that money to bring some happiness.
Jim, I really have a problem. Jim, I never have money left for dental.
A lot of people have a problem. Cash.
Good idea. I think you really need to buy right away.
After all, money is only paper metal when you put it to use.
I never have money left.
But we've already decided to buy.
Impulse.
so dark.
Nobody can see what's happening.
Worry, little doctor. Just starting the show. You'll get your eyes back tomorrow.
Good morning.
It's a nice, quiet morning.
You've been listening to a lot of
if it's
space.
Could ever be attacked,
and now,
if what we call the
you'll be hearing
ego,
a lot less.
You get to recline in that big, fat, juicy waffle. Bean.
I think we should distinguish.
Yes, Cute Bean now owns the show.
The way of powers and the way of
we'll be reporting to him after work.
I don't know if that's possible. A bean waffle is all bumpy.
Reaches out to an almost...
There's no show. Gabo Fam's House of Waffles.
They're working on the transmitter tonight.
Maybe House of Waffles. I saw that movie.
Yeah, the waffle started collapsing at the end on Vincent Rice.
That's right. And it all went up in a scary flame on the edge of the stove.
No, we have to start up. It's Doctors at Dawn.
Do we have to?
Oh, you know, there's a show where you can call up on the radio and hear yourself talk.
Yeah, it's real neat and everything.
There's these other guys there, too, but, you know.
Yeah, it seems like, I mean, the show's so bad, anybody could do it.
You know how it is with this thing. It's like little Lotrans revolving around your head. And then, you know, they're back next weekend. No big deal. It's like they never left, right? It's like you never left. Right, right. This is the show that dare not speak its name.
Right.
Okay, next doctor, please. Step up to the white line.
Yes, and what about all the nurses for Nardini?
And what about all the Narnian numbskulls, those pops called lion beaters and back beaters?
Yes, come on, come on, quiet down, quiet down now. Dr. Hal means no harm.
I was only attempting to do my duty, son. Someday you'll understand and do otherwise.
Nurses, nurses, doctors, please.
There's too much laughing and...
This is very embarrassing.
Sorry.
Sorry, Dr. Hal.
The auditorium isn't cleared right now. Dr. Hal will have to take the entire hospital out for breakfast this morning. Or kill me.
Hold on just a minute. Something's happened. Good morning. I don't know. We can't find out. Good morning.
We just got here. We haven't woken up yet.
I thought you were dead.
Oh, this is terrible. I wish we could just go back to the way it was only a minute ago.
Can we just replace the carpet in there?
Oh, if only I hadn't voted for the president.
All over the
if only I had voted for some other president. This might have happened a minute later instead of a minute before.
Or to some other generation.
Yeah, well,
not us.
Not me.
Not me.
Not you, Janer.
Not me.
No, it wasn't my fault, they all said, as they fell into the...
Not you, Janer, not you.
Thanks to Ralph Nader, huh?
Stop it, I can only take so many of the sound effects at once.
Oh, right, okay.
Just give me another cup of rubber cement, and I'll get started here on the 18th book.
He caused all
this time you promised I could have...
A check.
He destroyed our timeline.
Oh, chapter, right, I'm sorry.
Chapter.
Yeah, not a check, a chapter, yeah.
Bob writing so hard, I don't have enough money to buy it all.
He's a big stealer.
If you don't have any money, it makes the church stop.
Hi, this is the sperms. Don't worry about us. There are billions and billions of us, and we'll bury you.
Those were the subgenius sperms. Those were the happy little ones that stay alive even though they're in the sea. They're doing their little rifle exercises. These guys are motivated.
Those were spurious sperms. You could call them spermatozoon fatuus or fatuus.
You could, but it takes too long to say that. See, when we have to call up the sperm reserves, we have to get them out there right away. We can't have long names and long-winded stuffed shirt titles.
Okay, okay. We're going to have our first song tonight. It's called Poster of Dobbs, okay. The song we wrote when we were on vacation in Jamaica, and Paul's going to sing this one for you.
I am not.
Well, okay, let's all.
I want time and a half. So it's the middle of the night, in case you haven't noticed.
Time and a half.
And travel
open this time. Time and
no,
a half.
No, for anti-musicians, it's only like 10:30 in the morning.
Well, I'm trying to emerge from a cocoon of hearing social
noise. Yes. Aren't we all?
Well, that's good.
No reason. But I want to just come and talk about it with you, because you're doctors.
Well, just sit down right here. Open up your very soul. Every other
I'm just realizing that I have a problem with the first step to solving it, and then someone told me about you, and so here I am.
Climbed inside the show.
Yeah.
What do you think?
Don't hurt yourself.
Hey, Gary.
But you're a doctor,
I think
too,
I see a checkup ahead.
Okay, well, just try to here, take these four steps and see if you can pull it out of the
here, just watch these guys.
Okay,
disgusting. Wait, there's no signature on this check. We just kill another innocent
man. Makes me wonder about where medical science is leading
to. What are we going to do with the body?
And you're about to ask these guys for advice.
The way you guys go on, I know what the face is. Radio?
He didn't turn his on, I think.
Turned on? Today. No, this show's like what they, you know, it's the opposite of a turn on.
Oh, that's why you're listening.
Hello?
We're not being heard.
We're holding this position until dawn.
That's one of the most obscene and contorted positions I've ever seen, Jerry, but police yesterday were looking for an ambulance stolen through Kingman's Square in the house.
Ah, yes.
Picking up an injured
Let's try again.
Woman.
What do you have?
If you hang up on me again, your body will self-perpetuate in shopping malls forever and ever.
We're isolated from your curses, young man.
Yeah, that's right.
Look at him. He's crawling around inside the show.
But they've done a wonderful job. It looks 100% better.
Drag it over here.
It looks like it's dead.
But the blood in his eyes
set it up on the table, Doug. Push the face into sort of a smile. Put some headphones on it.
I heard enough.
This is an alert.
Oh, and we start the war over again. Okay, we've got to go slow motion over these frames.
Look at those beautiful explosions.
As we talk about once again. The slow motion reproduction. Now,
don't
what we'd like to see.
Look at the slow motion flash, or you'll go blind.
There's
slow motion
of origin of projectile somewhere central Bolivia, South America. This is
the Septimus Church recommends that you always wear an eye patch, so that just in case you are looking
where?
In the direction of the flash,
only
you
one
are...
eye.
Where will I go?
Only
don't be like
one eye.
One eye. Save one eye for
Bob.
On the left. Oh, come on! Stop all this. Stop the doctors. Yes, and too many doctors. Constantly here at this hour. As we stand up in here and watch the last of the subgenius troops fighting against the Puzzling Evidence forces in the desert. Back there you can see Puzzling Evidence.
I'm down here in the command center. Puzzling Evidence forces are about a mile from your house. You might as well just give up. I can see where Sandy tried to get through, but... Sniper. Who is that sniper? Is that Hagen? No, it's Buck.
Please stop.
Sorry, you could have done more than listen to the radio, but now it's too late. Now you only have a minute left.
Yes, and that
it will seem like hours.
It'll last forever.
The whole show will flash before your ears. Don't listen too closely or you'll go deaf.
Doctors were swirling around the room.
You now, little Palmer. Clouds of irradiated
You'll
air.
You'll be dead in only 20
trying to...
Don't let it upset you, little doctor.
But the ear is really, just really messed up still.
Yeah, can't you do something?
What?
It doesn't look a bit like
I
it did when it was alive.
I told you to use the size 5. If you'd used the size 5, it would all be fine right now.
I didn't know
if my conscience
came in stereo.
Yes. Jerry was stupid enough to drink coffee, and now he's off on his own show, not paying attention to the cues.
If you were a subgenius, of course, you too would have to get up at 4:30 and go to some... other radio stations and stop this show by being on that show.
When they show that movie, I'm just going to go down on my shoulder.
Yeah, good idea, because TV bombers will be over us in less than 10 minutes. And the TV missiles will start taking off from the inside of everybody's couches, and the little TV missiles will start flying out of the refrigerator. There'll be little TV missiles landing everywhere. No, this is a tape.
Oh, look out, we got a hypnopedia on the radar here.
Okay.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, you two call her on the midnight flight. Puzzling Evidence is saving the subgenius forces out in the desert. I'm not on the show anymore. I'm home asleep. This is wonderful. I hate being on the radio. I'm asleep right now in my bed. I'm warm and everything's nice. And I won't have to get up for another 18 and a half hours.
Oh, look out. My bed's on fire.
Oh, that's all right. That's all right. There he goes. We'll take that Doug away and put in the new Doug here. Press the Doug button and start him up.
I've seen that face somewhere before.
It was on some horrible radio show in the 1980s.
Wow, can you feel that? It feels like they're shooting little things right through you.
Yeah, but somehow or the other, I feel my forehead. There's a hole in my forehead.
Yeah.
Plug it up.
No problem.
Nope.
Yes.
Hey, you guys are great.
Sorry.
What's going on here?
I don't know.
Once you're in, you can't get out.
Puzzling Evidence is a scary hour.
What's all this stuff on the walls?
You have to... Oh, those are theme ideas.
What?
We like to tack them up here and ignore them.
How long have they been here?
2 years almost.
Yeah, some of them.
We used one once.
What color were they originally?
White.
We used one of those ideas.
Gray, white, gray,
yeah, you
white.
You couldn't really tell.
Green, black, blue, orange.
How did they get that color?
Well, somebody came along and set the outer ones on fire, and they just kind of burned down to the wall there.
And that caused the symbols.
Those are the ones we used, right?
And that, did someone draw those, or did they just...
We paid this guy from Calyx to come over here and think them up.
Yeah.
Oh, would you like to be killed?
Oh, yes.
Okay, ready?
I'm on a stage.
Here goes.
Him called Bebelus.
They call him Bob.
Same damn
fool. No. Good morning. Bob.
I'm very disappointed.
Yep. Oh, no,
your time is up. Time for commercial.
Oh, okay. Go ahead. Do the commercial.
Do something commercial.
Okay, let's go to the commercial now.
I mean nothing. I mean, this is the Church of the Subgenius. You don't really expect nothing from them guys. They ain't got nothing better to talk about than you and your relationship to the Subgenius Church and exactly what's going to happen to you when you stand up on that white stripe and have Dobbs remove your wallet. Yes, it's true. You can have your wallet personally removed by Bob, although I would never, ever consider it myself. I voluntarily sent mine in years ago. But you, unbeliever, can personally be defiled and demunified and devalued by Dobbs. It's true. You think it sounds awful? Well, it does sound awful. It sounds terrible.
If I die before I wake, I know my wallet he will take.
If even the Smurfs are armed in this sector.
Yes, we've sold weapons to everybody, and they're ready to use them. On us!
Yeah, right. So I got scary.
Yes, little Funto had bitten the head again, and I was hiding under the table.
Oh, it looks like Funto was loose and running down the streets of the city.
Yeah, so what?
It's the end of the war. Nobody cares anymore.
It's the end of the world, coincidentally, and we're all here to celebrate.
An orange.
As we float up into the upper atmosphere, tiny little particles.
Yes, sure is funny.
It's comfy, too.
Time, it could be a difficult and... Hey, listen, don't push me around. Doctor. This could be your
you
show. It could be anybody's show. I'm not sure what's going on. Hey, come on, get out of the way, Paul. I've got to do these things. I got to mix this stuff up. Oh, look out! Oh, I must have put the wrong stuff in. This is not Showstopper. This is Show Expander.
Oh.
Quick, close the doors. It's going to fill up the station. Quick, close all the windows, too. Oh, look at this stuff. It's...
And I own the Subgenius radio show.
I felt like I was dreaming. I could see Paul trying to reach for the stop button on the panel, but he was floating away from me at the speed of light. We need to go on the air now.
Palmer had a terrible dream.
Can you hang out first?
Palmer dreamed he was on the radio.
Yeah,
I can tell. True. This is the astronaut.
It looks like Jake's about to fall off the edge of the show.
He just ate four moths before he came on, too.
I'll make it to the end.
Yes, he ate four of those beautiful little brown mothballs before he came on the show.
Okay.
That whole church show just piped down.
Yeah, it's just that noisy little church. Hey, look, get Funjo away from the microphone.
Well, you'd be surprised how coherent it sounds when you listen to it today.
We have to clean this mess up. If she gets excited, this...
Cut the bad parts out. Right now, let's not even bother anyone.
Okay, snip, fix. Now it's all
okay.
Better.
Here we go.
The new show.
Welcome to the Saturday morning Subgenius Radio Show.
Hi, Bob.
Hi, Bob.
Or just kill me, children.
With a tried and proven plan to follow.
I can't say
it. We'll show you how to stop
using the show never got to see
are electronically interwoven into a pleasant musical background.
We made everyone get up and listen. And nothing was funny.
Recording, everything's going fine.
We got calls from Denver and Dallas.
We get calls Hollywood from the Palace. Other side of the earth on this program.
What is the other side of the
hail,
earth?
Hail. The other side of the earth is all here now. We're past it to little pieces. And we're going to import China to Iowa and build big hills of what's left over.
It's a great party down here at the studio. We're throwing these cups and saucers around and catching them very skillfully.
Please, I'm having lots to think about.
These Subgenii people are not part of the conspiracy.
This is like the case we had earlier this week where we treated a resident for an impacted Sony Walkman.
Well, you know, in a cave in ancient Babylonia, they actually found in this cave the ancient cassettes on which Jesus spoke.
That's true, Kendi. What is the archaeological evidence for the famous Shroud of Bob?
Pipe. There was a pipe implanted on the shroud, and then bound by his genitals, there was nothing. Bob impressed the images by blowing smoke that formed the picture that represents his pipe, and of course, the part by his genitals where there was nothing.
And scientists are agreed that although Bob may not have himself impressed the image, everyone else who was present was certainly impressed.
That can calculate if you're not careful.
I hope he can hear you. Thank you for all of your participation in this transcription experiment, and hope that you aren't sickened by strange, distorted musical behavior.
In fact, in my book, you're nowhere. He's right again. You blinded me. There he is.
My God.
Now, that's not fair. You blinded me, but you can't read his voice back to him. That's hardly fair.
I can talk and everything. Well, I'm going to use this opportunity right now to tell all the people that are at home asleep that they're missing out on this wonderful war program. Yes, welcome to the Minute After. KPFA's own version of the after effects of the wonderful future that's awaiting us all. And here comes the first float in the parade here.
It's hard to believe that a bomb as ugly as this could look as beautiful like this.
Boy, you know, the Pakistanis went all out this year. I'd have to say that's
amazing.
The prettiest float this I've seen yet.
And the bomb itself is a piece of wonderment, Dr. Vrides. Is made out of completely recycled and stolen atomic material. But it works nearly as good as the bomb that California has.
Well, I remember the one South Africa dragged out here last year. It seemingly seemed a little bit grim, but you couldn't argue with the function.
But it did have a lovely golf motif.
I have to give them credit for being the only people stupid enough to actually use their own bomb on themselves.
Bob. There really is a Santa Claus.
Is Bob any longer relevant to the show? Is Bob with the show any longer, or has he moved on to better religions?
Maybe there were better things over the horizon.
Yes, they saw a bigger church, a fancier church that made more money, the church that was right here in Berkeley, or Oakland, or somewhere.
Wherever you were right now. Maybe there was something down the road. Maybe the world was continuing to turn. Maybe the shadow just wasn't on Dobbs' nose the wrong way.
Yeah, that's true. Maybe some genius wasn't everything. Maybe there was something else.
Maybe some genius was just another chapter in some other book. And now we were turning the page.
Yes, and as we say goodbye to scary subgenius and hello to the new religion, plenty of water every day. We wonder what kind of God is going to come bother us now. How many Jesus will it be? How much will they weigh? What kind of anti-Jesus spray we have to use on our windowsills in the kitchen? I don't know. Last time I had to light my fire on... I can't even say it. I had to light my house on fire just to get rid of the heliopter Jesus. Yes, and the thesaurus Jesus, that was the scariest of all. Nothing could get rid of it. Maybe we should turn the page back to where there still was some genius.
Who was the next deity that would show up and insist that we write his life story into the book? Into some other book, into another record, into another movie?
I don't know. Maybe it was Frontubus, maybe it was Hinto. I don't expect us to be there. We'll be in the audience, just like you, watching the real subgeniuses.
And maybe meeting some of those real subgeniuses and being able to push them from the balcony all the way down to the floor and killing the video crew so no record will be made of this horrendous event. Here you can see the priests as they carry the event toward the event window to push it out and out into the cosmos. Ah, yes, and what a heavy event it was.
Yes, it's true. We'll be marching through the audience into the restroom to try to rid ourselves of any... any of that.
Huh?
Oh, Doctor, you're still on the transmission.
I'm just reading off this paper in here.
Well, that's all right.
Right here? You know where it says?
Calm
it says
down.
Here.
Next move.
Yeah, next move.
Check orange
okay, that's your
inside
line.
Helmet.
Doctor, what are you doing up there?
Well...
Now listen closely, listeners, because we're just about to tell you the secrets of the church and why no one longer.
Just let me show you this one procedure.
It looks like Commander Hughes is taking off his helmet.
I see.
He's trying to get out of
here.
I can hear the funny music beginning now.
Dr. Vrides, are you anywhere in the vessel?
I'm down here.
Dr. Vrides.
Guys, I don't think it's safe to come out of the ship.
He's gone down to the alien bin.
Yes, he certainly has. Down there with the tiny little aliens.
Oh, they're so cute, too. Look, they're waving to me.
Are you going to
the
little town of Wisconsin?
You'll find out. Here,
I'll hold the microphone.
I see it
now. It's so unstable.
Now, listen closely to this, Chris, because we're just about to tell you the secrets of the... of the church that will allow no one longer, any longer, any longer, longer. Why no any longer?
He can't see anymore. He's useless to us.
He's being wrapped in a flag
and given a burial in space.
And he's now been jettisoned.
Let us now play the pre-recorded hymnal. Ah, yes, the spaceman's funeral. It's so beautiful. There he goes. Twirling towards the sun in his glittering coffin of steel, far from his mother planet. Another brave serviceman.
Little Bobby Brown.
The boat ran, we might have enough fuel to reach the station.
True, somebody had to go. Somebody had to be sacrificed for the doctors. Yes, the tiny door, there are enough headphones in there. The tiny door and the supplies that everlastingly fill the air are here with us tonight.
No more people in the airlock, Doctor.
The telephone company's new service.
There's only three of us on the vessel now. I don't know. I think everybody else on Earth's dead.
Where'd the staff go?
Well, let's just try some old-time music then.
They've all turned off their radios. All of Northern California is studiously ignoring, listening to us. This is me radio. My show. It's my... You're listening to me. That starts with an M. Listener Free Me Radio.
Two and three times over.
Uh-huh, you're funny.
You're not.
He invented a snap off of that.
Oh, yeah.
Is no robot.
So
there are no.
I can't stand this fucking hiding anymore.
Oh. Jesus Church. Finally,
looks like
all
the
this
priests
time,
have reached the event window.
And the priests. They finally have shed the skin of the church. And we're ready to find something better. We will not look back. We will not think of the bad times.
Hey, maybe we're gonna be okay.
The checks that never came. The Vreedies that complained. No.
And never came.
Now there's a happy Vreedies and checks that always come because the new religion really pays.
This will happen to you by turning the show off.
Oh, no, it seems the priests are going off. Are having I see spasms of joy.
Yeah,
that's just the way they do it out here.
It was my God.
Repeat those words.
You write about it in the book.
It was ceremonial head players.
That was
Stephen Bob on live broadcasting.
He was looking at the
ceremonial head players.
After a while, finding something that he could do. The cult of Front Tubbs was before Doug, and he hated it.
Dobbs
Town will enable me to make a living for my family.
Yes, so he turned to Front Tubbs there in the Martini Lounge and said, I really shouldn't be doing this stuff again.
I just wanted a couple pages, you know.
Whatever your real name is, you're funny.
Simply, you really think that gave you that new dryer? Or
okay, you funny too, Carl.
Something like it. Maybe a food budget for the next year.
You put it in
maybe
the toaster. When you butter your toast before you put it in the toaster.
Oh, sorry, listener, that's impossible. If
you butter the dough and waffles and the burning waffles and the bleeding waffles. Bleeding waffle good, healed waffle bad. We've heard all these old jokes.
You have to come up with very new religions, and then we'll really appreciate
and
it. But otherwise,
we'll expect some call from somebody in Arkansas.
Up good there, morning. One, new right? Show.
Hello,
there's
Arkansas.
A giant airplane marker which shows the way to our secret operating booth. And here, we're going to move it by the strength of one hand donated. Many people wouldn't be able to heave it or budge it, but we can lift it easily on one finger, the index finger.
Yes, we were aboard the USS Heavis.
Right, they made all those people take acid in the 60s just by playing Beatles out of the cave. He's been
okay.
There
go on out, listener.
All female subgenies, please understand that actually all male
subgenies
are not in their
best
interest.
From the Gabrofram's best Mimico Hits album.
That's mostly on Over the Edge. This is a very positive program. Now, the subgenius program only has two more shows to go before 1984.
Pay the bills and take your pills.
Here we go. Here's some pills now. Okay, hand the pills to the listener there and let him on.
You can tell your true bobhead by fucking every glass
take
of
this
water.
Pill, please.
Ow! Okay, bye, listener.
You've re-enveloped us, and we are going to be living in 1984 for a whole year.
No, I'm going to go back to 1948.
Well, sounds like you should listen to Sunday's prophecy program, or Monday morning. Prophecy program, and then
yes.
You'll
get
be clean and work. He's trying to pretend he's the Meyer answering machine. That's a pitiful attempt, but successful, of course. We'll leave you on as a background sound effect. Okay, now.
Mr. Nelson, yes, and Skippy's wife is getting
that's right. Let them eat yellow.
I mean, when you see a bank burning down, well, that's me.
And when you see a lawnmower chop off a toe, well, that's me.
And when you see a fallen
politician turned back on, that's me.
And when you see the Golden Gate Bridge with no traffic on it, well, that's me, too.
You're riding down in that limousine to do that. Well, that's me too. And you hear the three shots coming from the front side.
I'm
simply
great.
Looking for a humorous feature story to cap that late-breaking feature about
well,
the squirrel that ate two fingers on President Reagan's
head. You may have had that, because I have had it. No, I'm high on the real thing. I'm high on J.R. Bob Dobbs.
President Reagan is also known as the squirrel's friend
universe,
because of the delightful zag nuts that he tosses on the White House lawn.
Probably saved the
doctor. Yes, welcome to the chaos.
He may mess you up.
That car might get driven right into this studio by a bad West Coast listener.
Think of that,
well, that's me too, and
I can't wait for that show. Personally,
when the higher up officers in the subgenius church are all blamed for the tragic death toll on the show. The plague show. Well,
that's
me too. And
actually, the Over the Edge program is more guilty of that than you are. But that's another story. Anyway, I want you all to make the best of what time we have remaining before 1984. And I know it'll be a different game then.
There's just a little bit of that so-called church era left.
That's a metro mess.
Caller, you have 45
metro
seconds
mess.
Fire
the
remaining
metro.
Left of Radio Life. We suggest you make the most of it.
Pretty good, Matt Dang, you listening?
You're still stuck in a stupid, ugly world.
During the Paris Commune, they ate the trunks of the elephants.
Burning pieces of collar? They found burning pieces of collar, Gary.
Okay. They are $40,000 a year that I get. That's something. Well, I'll tell you, the amount of hours that I have to put in this show, all you have to do is turn on your radio and listen. That's it.
The doctors told us afterwards that we were clinically dead. Somehow woke up.
It was hard, but the blood in our eyes, they had this kind of ray that made the blood in our eyes kind of coagulate and kind of start bulging out.
We thought
but then we left our bodies, so we didn't mind about our
we
eyes.
We thought we had seen a vision from the Lord Jesus God, or maybe one of those space people, but it turned out we were only near Fort Blixby.
Yes,
I got a bad yakatisma.
Oh, I didn't need to bring it on again.
Stick it.
The thing is, no matter how hard you try, you can't get the doctors back into show.
Like Velcro. Puzzling the evidence offers us a grand vision of the universe as one thing.
Come on. They don't have to wake up now.
Oh, okay, let's
the night show is going to be here. Oh, 20 more minutes, the night show is going to be here.
Out of the marine, I know what the phone can do for a man and getting him off on the right foot in life.
You will be able to
it was cold out there in the phone booth, and the wires whistled, and the little birds were asleep in their little tiny phone booth.
There's the audience. Look to the other side.
You can see dragging down the street, trying to get help.
Yeah.
No, ugly, huh?
And whenever you
no
dimes. The green heroes say...
That's why I'm here.
No dimes.
But to call the show costs dimes. And to do the show costs dollars. And to hold the show up for a KPFA.
He's a big that's not good enough on this
you
one.
Know all the time.
See what happens? Even if we talk about the dimes, we've got to talk about quarters. Yes, everything goes up.
Can't justify. I guess they could cut someone's throat and stuff like that. That's what I agree. How far?
We're really after Jesus. Well, he's still flying, Mika. What a guy.
He's the 20-inch high Jesus, the 90-foot Jesus.
Oh, yeah.
And the cornbread Jesus.
And here's a little...
cornbread Jesus.
Spinkies Jesus.
Wafer Jesus.
The walking wounded Jesus. The
we need a wafer to
living
walk in.
Jesus. Slouching into Bethlehem to be born.
And the bicycle mechanic Jesus, and the service station Jesus, and all the most useful...
To me, you're the most wonderful, lovable, generous human being in the whole world.
No, I'm a very sick man.
The you don't have to worry about the day after
manufacturer Jesus,
because there's a world the little Jesus that will make everything
car bombs. Yes, it was Jesus that...
Well, you know what? One thing I'll tell you, I would much rather live dead than in a communist country.
Well, Jesus, that could be like Satan. I'm telling people, you know, don't believe the hype.
The happy Geraldine took to signing herself to Balfour as she watched here on the telephone talking to her young friend. But subsequent developments proved this course to be premature, since she was sending letters to complain.
And you saw Tallulah Bankheist, Fluff Girl, Fairman Barney, and Ginger all performing at Satan's Holiday 666. And the era of evil has begun. Satan has arrived. And you know what? He's an okay guy. He's all right. You know, just shake his hand, have a drink. This is Satan's era, 666, because, you know, because the omen came out anyway. But another Hole in the Head Film Festival is showing the film Evil. We're getting now splatter theater, splatter movies from Greece. This is happening this weekend. Splatter movies and, you know, exaltations of Satan. Simultaneous, instantaneous, worldwide, computer god, Frankenstein, nightmare, living death, slavery. Reread my letter. This is the time of a stage like Hollywood, sounding like Bernard Herrmann, John Williams, Scum on Top, Stage Like Hollywood, Computer God, Frankenstein, Nightmare, Living Death, Sleep. Where is your mad giggle now? Where is your mad Google now? Do you know where your Google is? What are the people going to do? But this is the great, of course, this is the greatest day in American history in, I would say, 4 years. Yes, this very day, the second most evil man in the universe has been killed. Yes, admit it, it's a great day. Don't hide the fact that you are happy. That al-Zarqawi is dead. The only thing better than that would be Osama bin Laden's death, which I'm going to personally call a wildcat strike. Work off, day off, vacation, holiday for one day. That's right. A wildcat strike of one day of everyone in the country out of work, out of school, the day they killed Osama bin Laden. Yes, just light up those cigarettes, folks. Now, I want you to talk to
what they call the refrigerator lady. She's going to tell you about Westinghouse for a moment. But just tell me something. You are going to be happy the day they killed Bin Laden. Why have they taken so long? Is he really that hard to kill? He's in Pakistan. Everyone knows that. What's up with that? In any case, they managed to stumble into al-Zarqawi and kill him. Let us all do a little jig and shoot our guns in the air. That's what I'm doing this holiday. That's right, folks. Shoot your guns in the air and dance a little jig. But don't use your hips when you dance, because that would be a satanic dance. We don't want to get into all that. You can hear people, you can hear them loading up. Of course, the M31 carries a magazine of 32 clips. Well, I won't get into all that whole business, but you can see people shooting each other and people dying on probably 6-7% of the channels now available. And let me tell you, there's nothing like it. The only thing that's sexier than people being killed is products. Yes, products, folks. You've heard of soda and green. Well, products. That's where you are. Of course, now that we have the soundtrack, maybe it's Hitchcock. Hopefully, I'm not on the air anymore. Just gonna have to have some of this Habafrop Zippy off. You know, the only hope for you is Bob and Slack. There's no other way you can possibly survive the upcoming catastrophe and apocalypse without Bob.
I found it!
And Slack.
That dude is scary.
Fight for Bob. Kill for Bob.
Tell him to stop talking like that. I'm scared now. Why did I turn on your radio station? Now I won't sleep all night long.
All right, keep moving. Keep moving. We've got to crush out all resistance. Where's Bob? Where is he? Oh my God. We're not gonna shoot them? We're just gonna take them prisoner? Alright. Tie her up. Tie her up and, just hook her ankles to the bar there. Yeah, I know she's crying, and I don't care. I'm just going to have to... Oh, wait. Wait a minute. Looking out the window, it looks to me like... Steven Spielberg is coming. Quick!
This is Pennywise. Joan, you're next.
Yes. Oh, my God. Thank God I'm on PBS. But I'm a sub-genius, dammit. I need Slack. I need Slack. And above all, I need...
Time to wake up.
Have a prop zippy lop. I need prop.
No money.
I know she's cute. But I need Glenn Campbell and Bob. Please, Bob.
I got some napalm.
Collect in the autumn mist in the land,
land of poverty.
In the land of quality.
The land of poverty.
Poverty.
In quality and in quantity.
Here's the DMZ. Our faithful pastor.
Well, you need to go to DMV.
Frolicked in the napalm mist.
And it's all over
and
me.
It's all okay with me.
Yeah, well, here's my kid was born with an arm on his back due to napalm. So I don't have to worry about scratching his back. But
he
otherwise, I got a daughter
his own
with
back.
Eyeballs. No, they need to go to DMV.
The whole idea of having a whole show on this highway in the middle, but I'm afraid I'm going to get run over.
I know, it's like I'm talking to you on the eastbound side, and I'm on the westbound side trying to get to the center divide.
Take your life in your hands up.
Whoa.
Damn.
Whoa, whoa.
Wait.
Whoa. Hey, are you okay? He died. Is he alive? Oh, man. What happens when I run out of gas? He had a gas tank.
Man, I'm fine.
Are you alive?
I'm okay, yeah.
Oh,
are
good.
You okay?
Well, then what was all that? Oh, wait, where'd all the traffic go?
I'm okay. I don't know. I can't feel my left arm. Wait a minute.
Here, I got another one in the...
Whoa.
I got one under the spare tire.
Oh, wait a minute. Where is it?
I don't know. Where's my car?
Where's my arm?
It's. There it is. It's stuck to the tire.
Oh, man, get it.
Oh. See it?
Hurry, okay, get it. You know.
Hold on, I'll be back.
Yeah. Oh, man.
I can't do it. They just took the ass.
You can't find it?
No, man.
It would be cooler than Mark Pauline.
Oh, man.
On my arm.
Oh, man. You know what? I'm trying to get your arm, my leg fell off.
Oh, man. You know, I hate this traffic. You know, they just go too fast. You lose your arm, you lose your mind, you lose your ears. Perhaps the bomb. Did anyone see the omen? No, let me tell you. I didn't see it either. But another hole in the head film festival. It's called Evil. It's the bloodiest, most gory movie ever. And then there's another one that's called something else. It's incredibly bloody and gory. And then there's another one that's called something else. It's incredibly bloody and gory. And then, anyway, I'm going to go to some of them. Hey, what happened to Flavel? Ed Drummond, I understand he's trying to reproduce.
Flying over San Pablo Bay.
Mutated, genetically distorted genetic trail in the form of future subgeniuses with Chaos Kitty. And they have a new pupa. They have a new pupa in which to gestate for their infernal hell child after 666. You guys didn't see Ginger. It was incredibly sexy, but also the sex anyway. But 666 is past us now, and you know what?
We live
in
66
because they shot.
I tell you, on 666,
so
I got 666.
We have kicked Satan's ass.
Oh, wow. Damn, would they drop us off in the middle of nowhere again?
Owls are calling.
Do enough to him. Don't you think?
What? I don't think we're going to get any more of his sermons anymore.
Sitting there with his...
What? I do think there should be a wildcat strike when they get Bin Laden. But hey, you know, I'm not trying to dwell on the dark side. It's the bright side I'm looking at.
Bin Laden's the Phantom Menace.
That's right, and I'm trying to look on the bright side. I mean, what about Dick Hyman?
He's like a poltergeist. He only appears.
There you go. What about Dick Hyman, Ray?
Who?
Dick Hyman, who invented the lounge cocktail music.
Is Dick Cheney the Antichrist?
Dick Cheney? Well, all I can say is lick, dick, and bush. Which you can say legally over the air because I was reading it. I
hey,
read it
on the door.
You have got to go by the book on this. I was reading that the whole time. You can say it as long as you're quoting someone. Dick? Is the first name Bush, is the last name Lick, is a normal, Bum Shakalaka Laka Pow Now Now. And Lick is a normal, plural function. That's not one of the seven words. Fortunately, my radio and my place is cool funky. You guys have some kind of weird stuff. What happened to, where's the hell baby of Viral and Fantasy? Where is Dr. Howland Dow? I know where they are, never mind. But, you know, Pepe's birthday is July. But, July 5th, Roger's cutting up now. Apparently he left the Negra in Tallulah's shower drain. Yes.
Visiting the orphanages, the president is often accompanied by a huge entourage, including reporters, Secret Service agents, and his special undercover orphan bodyguard brigade. Landing strips have been built to accommodate Air Force One at each of the orphanage sites. Uncle Newt's exits have become legendary. Thanks to his White House special effects staff, even his departures are a celebration of American ingenuity. To pry himself away from the grateful throngs of types, he carries candy and lottery tickets that he strews throughout the crowd. Then, after a hearty wave at the top of the steps, he enters Air Force One, which disappears in a huge neon-colored cloud only seconds later. His visits touch his heart. He especially loves hearing the cheer that goes up as the orphans see the beautiful spectacle of his plane disappearing in a brilliant flash. Poor kids, the Newt often says, as he looks down toward the crowd of orphans getting smaller and smaller. They don't know it's all done with smoke and mirrors. Coming soon, more political conversations overheard by the same authors. Deficit Attention Disorder and Me. By Bill Clinton. The author tells how his failure to balance a budget ruined his life and how he bounced back from catastrophe. Overcoming Chronic Fatigue Syndrome by Fidel Castro. Unable to wear anything but military gear for decades, the author describes how he underwent fashion desensitization and was finally coaxed into designer suits. The Chelsea Prophecies. The former president's daughter teams with an Ouija board to create a philosophy for living.
Gore. it's Greece. Greece has produced its first square splatter gore movie. And you've got to go see it. It's called Evil, and it's just nothing but gore. And I can't stress how important this is. But, you know, don't get too scared, folks, because we're actually trying to be scary by playing scary music. And so, you know, just listen to my voice and be calm. Everything's fine. Just try to fall asleep.
Sister, you're the one that dropped this woman. We're here from New Mexico. Tell us something about her.
Well, she has been coming to our services for about a month or two now, and it has acted up many times, but not nearly this bad. And we have fought and prayed with her until we've been so worn out that we wasn't able to hardly carry on with our other services. And we were very glad when God made the way for us to bring her here. And two, one other sister and I drove all the way here to bring her. And he even told us on the way here, said, "My, you women sure are brave to go this far with me." And my, he's been horrible. I'm telling you, if you don't know demons, just the crap piles, you get acquainted with them. They're horrible.
Oh, God.
What's some of the things he's been saying?
That's disgusting.
Well, he hates her husband awfully bad, and he hates her child, and of course he tells us all the time that he's Lucifer, which I feel like he's bragging like he's the biggest one. I don't know. He's horrible. That's all I know, brother.
He actually ate.
How long she had this thing?
Well, she says she's had it for 27 years. It came through witchcraft, she says, and she didn't. She was in Catholicism and didn't know that she had it until about 3 years ago. She tried to come to Christ, and she's been trying to come ever since, and he has blocked the way as much as he could. Although she says herself that she's saved, but I don't know. I mean, it's up to her and God about that.
Thank you. Oh, my God.
Glory to God. But I say right now, if you don't know anything about demons, they're the most horrible things I've ever met. I don't know why God let her come our way, because I felt like the least one among them. But God let her come there, and we did all that we could for her, and I felt definitely led to bring her here.
You believe God's going to set her free?
Yes, I do. Yes. He's got to set her free, Brother Allen. He's just got to set her free.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Oh, hallelujah.
Here's
praise
a lady
Bob.
Minister on the platform. She's seen this woman. She's just come into this meeting here in New Mexico. What was it?
I was in Las Cruces, New Mexico a few weeks ago.
Oh,
and I just put off the bus
so
about 10 minutes later. We went over and prayed with this woman all evening. And prayed with her for quite a while, and she was relieved somewhat.
Oh.
But this pain, what drags her down is the pain in her chest.
Oh,
and when we were praying with this pain, he would manifest himself. Then seven ladies met together and prayed with her from 10 o'clock in the morning until about 7 o'clock at night. And she just prayed and prayed and prayed and prayed, friends. And the thing attacked me three times. And if it hadn't been for one lady around, I don't know what would have happened. This woman is a sweet woman. She wants deliverance. and how it happened, I know she doesn't mind. When she was a young girl, there was a lad that wanted to marry her, and she wouldn't marry him. And he cast a spell upon her. And then her parents took her to a witchcraft doctor because of the pain in her chest. They wanted her to be healed, and they didn't want any other place to go. She was Roman Catholic, and every year they say they keep that spell cast upon her in Las Cruces, New Mexico. And we go down to her home, drive down to her home to get her for a prayer meeting. You could see the evil powers around the home. You could feel it in the house. You could feel the force of the devil there. The devil tries to kill her, tries to kill a child, and hates her husband. And whenever
I
had her husband and child, she couldn't talk. When this American daughter just keeps her speechless and wordless, she can't talk. And the pain would travel around her body all around her. And then she'd act, as you saw, like a snake and swear in Spanish. And, well, there's a lot of other...
Russian in Spanish tonight.
Jesus is going to set her free. This is her night of glory. This is her night of deliverance.
I am the good one, the Olympian Rampart, the plan, the mighty paradise of slap that awaits all sub-genes.
27 years.
27
years? For all eternity.
So bad after all.
We want to help you.
Yes, the heaven of the sex.
Is it on the inside?
I have stood there. I have been among them.
Yeah?
Let me tell you.
Tell me.
They are sexy.
Yes.
It's on the inside.
So
how does it feel in there?
I feel much
it's
pain.
It's like making
you feel
love
much pain.
To
yes.
God.
It makes you hurt.
And yes.
Exactly. Where does it hurt?
It doesn't
does it
hurt
move around
anywhere.
In there?
Yeah. It's
a lot of
time.
I feel a lot of hurting.
Uh-huh.
Something chokes me.
Something chokes you?
Kind of like
is that what makes your tongue stick out?
It would be me.
Mm-hmm.
You know,
yes.
Woody and it hurts.
I know of a good second story. Wendy, you
and
can
I have a terrible burning feeling inside.
Your beings mingle.
There's something in there that talks.
Your beings mingle.
You can't
he
keep it.
He curses all the time.
He curses all the time. You can't keep the thing from talking.
Extraterrestrial sex bomb.
Hmm?
No, because the power is stronger than
when well, you are,
side, she'll get abducted by aliens.
A strong man, in other words, is that right?
By demons.
You feel it now, don't you?
Yes.
The satanic saucers.
It's in there, isn't it?
Yes.
Talk if you can.
Yes. I can feel he's in there, yes.
He's in there. He's hurting you now.
Any woman can.
You want to come out tonight?
Tell her to fall on her knife.
I have had that agonizing pain in my heart, in the heart region, someplace in the chest, for all those years.
How did you get this thing? You remember when it came?
Yes.
You must have been a young girl when it came the first time.
15 years old.
You were 15 years old.
It was a witchcraft spell that was cast on me.
Somebody cast a spell on you?
Yes.
When you were 15 years old, didn't they like you?
Well, I don't know. I don't know.
And you've had it ever since?
Ever since.
And you tried to get rid of it?
Yes.
The lady up there on the platform said she prayed for you for hours. For 7 hours.
Wrong.
You jumped on her 3 times. Do you remember that?
Hmm? No, sir. No.
You don't remember that?
Sorry. No. I can remember some of the manifestations of the devil, but not all. Sometimes he gets fully control of my mind.
You remember down here while I go through and shavings at me? She can't talk now. We're choking her. She's sticking her tongue out like a snake. This is the devil coming up in her. That old snake, that old serpent nature. Did you ever see a snake run its tongue out like that? You're looking at a devil.
Oil.
This woman speaks perfect English. She's an educated woman.
Power!
Curses.
I turned the mic off so you couldn't hear me. These kind of people come into our meeting by the hundreds. Sometimes we wrestle with them till 1, 2, 3 o'clock in the morning. But God always gives the victory. I don't remember one case that's ever been brought into our campaign for what God has given the victory. They don't all come quick. Some are stubborn.
When I was 15,
that's not like your power.
No.
Heal, I say, you can't cast me out. You have the power to cast me out.
Oh, is that so?
Yeah.
Never you a liar. You are coming.
I have deceived many, and I can deceive you too.
I will.
Yes? I challenge you, you devil!
I'm Lucifer, I can't come out of this woman! Lucifer, I can't come out of this woman!
Oh, you are Lucifer. You're coming out.
Powerful, you haven't got the power to cast me out!
Oh, it's that so?
I have deceived many, and I can deceive you too!
Devil, you are a liar.
I worship you.
I need you too, Mom! Yes.
I
am a Sabbath healer. Took me in his arms.
How many years
and he kissed me.
In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. I bind you, Satan. I bind you, devil. I bind you, foul boy. I chew you by Christ Jesus, your master. Come out of her, you devil, you, in the name of Jesus. I'm casting you out. Come out, you devil. Walk through thy faces. This is your palace no longer. I said come out. I said come out now. I said come out, you devil.
Some people
you
power.
She belongs to God. She belongs to God.
What?
I repeat, you chicken. Not to God. She does belong to God. She does belong to God.
Earlier, not unconscious, like each soul.
door flies up, and in rush his trooper chums, all most manly and warlike, except the one on the right who smacks his head firmly into the doorframe. As he totters forward, bemused, matters are not helped by his commander saying,
"See him."
They thought we'd never notice. Now wipe to exterior forest, end all day. Shining, self-sacrificing superhero, C-3PO, leans out from behind a tree to lure the troopers into an ambush. Well, in order to get the vast army of troopers to react on cue, they had to be able to hear me. A cunning scheme was employed to link up my radio mic to an amplifier, to a loudspeaker, to broadcast to the troops.
Action! Hello! I say, you! Over there! Were you looking for me?
I imperiously echoed around the forest, causing buzzards to lay eggs and gophers to... Anyway, to a man, each trooper turned and raised his blaster, terrified. Then, to a trooper, each man began to run towards me along the sylvan path. Really? Unrehearsed, the front one fell over. Mistake, I thought. Then another. Okay, I thought. Hearing my voice still echoing amongst the mighty trees, I began.
And number 12 is down, and it's number 3 in the lead. And the first leap, not running well, and coming up on the outside is number 5 with 7 closely behind. And very fresh, the next third is... Oh, and there goes number 10. What a fourth. But breaking through with a magnificent... Oh, no, he's down. But here we have a newcomer racing to take the lead as we come into the
overpalon. The director's megaphone drowned out my voice, but you got a round of applause for my race car. Sadly...
Oh, win in the end.
I picked up a helmet abandoned by an embarrassed trooper and put it on.
Oh, but we saved you.
You had more space than mine. Certainly enough room to spare me.
You can now dire. Oh, 300, oh no, 200 foals a year at approximately 200,000 to 500,000 dollars per stud fee. Barbaro was saved. This is an animal, a horse, that produces many millions of dollars a year of value. So-called value, money value. That was operated on hand from a giant swing in the water. Greatest geniuses of modern veterinary medicine.
Clean off the theme panels.
Yeah.
Yeah, the theme panel's broken.
Okay,
but hang on to the show real careful, Doug. Okay, we'll both erase this part of the show.
Take 6 hours, say 7 Hail Marys.
Which of the doctors is more funny than the other? Oh, no.
Hey, did you hear I taught my dog how to play cards?
No, but if you'll hum it, I'll try to pick it out of my ocarina.
What about Brad? Look at the window.
Did you see it? Oh, my God. No, I can't see anything.
There's something else on the edge. He's trying to get the engine off.
The show. I'm not that guy. Don't disconnect this guy. He's really good looking. I want him for later. Tune him in. Put him in a bag.
Time. There you go.
I mean, how can that be?
Someone bring me a drink.
Wait a minute, it's out there again.
There is the internet too. Yes, you are. Seven states and three federal agencies listen to the show constantly, monitoring the content, moving us into the
safe caller.
Yes, it probably is.
Well, you know, the great hamburger animal, scary than ever before. Venison, of course, you can't get anymore, but, you know, the great, I would prefer my venison not shot up with bird pellet like,
death is a lack of dollars? Bleeding head good, heal head bad. Welcome to the Cigarette Hour here in the Subgenius program. We're getting very, very cool.
Yeah.
Ever seen this?
So CK, yes.
A subgenius experience in a cool bar of your choice.
Give me a Mahoney,
a tall, cool drink of your choice. And the sex of your preference on your arm and something else on your mind. Yes, smoke in your eyes and hair in your drink. You've got problems, buddy. Yes, the health department hasn't been in here for a week and you're its first victim. Come down to Dobbstown and get Glanscaped. Clean up those unsightly spots on your face.
Control rolls from side to side in your vehicle. You find it harder to steer. You come down Highway 17 and turn your radio on to some strange show that you don't have any idea what's going on.
Open your window again. We'll try that again. Oops, I'm sorry. Okay, M too many radios.
I don't
look out. Come on. No, don't open the glove box now.
Your hands are cramping into it. A grip and you can't get
the dog. I'll vote for the doggy.
Ah, yes, one vote for the doggy. Well, thank you, sir, and good night.
Oh, my God, dog. Oh,
well, perhaps you spent your last minute calling a radio station.
Hoping you didn't party on no tools, no information whatsoever to give you. Well, you can call in to say yes. That Nancy Kent did it. I don't know. I hate cats. They make me itch. I'm allergic to doggy. Well, you know, that's not important to us. But we want to know who did. Who was the criminal? Who killed dogs? Was it Kitty? Or was it Breeze? Or was it
estimation of the specification? According to the authoritative.
Now, doctor's back on track for you.
Sensors indicate no sign of pursuer. No sign of pursuer? What kind of sensors were these? They couldn't keep their mind in the gutter where it belonged. And soon they were censoring everything. Your parents, your television, your family. Yes, they censored it all. Even the caller was scared. What caller? Are you still playing
well,
that message?
Where were you when the war started, caller? I was surfing with Bob.
You're no caller.
Oh, you're right. And neither is Bob.
You need a telephone.
Ah, right. Hello.
See?
Hello?
Hello.
Hello.
Good morning.
Good morning.
What's your
phone? How many of you are there?
None.
Let's see. Do you count the elevator boy?
We're all outside having a smoke.
There's a few of us.
The war started, and we all jumped in here and for shelter, and it turned out to be a radio station. Where are you?
Are there any women there?
Huh?
Are there any women?
Hello. Good morning.
Good morning.
Hi, what's for breakfast?
A kitty.
Oh, good. How are you doing it this morning?
Pretty good.
How are you cooking the kitty?
How are you cooking the kitty?
Well, microwave, of course.
Oh, boy, this is going to be fun.
Can we watch?
You know what? You know what I wish you'd do is bring the microwave down to the station.
They wouldn't send any in.
Why not?
Well, they wouldn't let us bring any.
They couldn't run in high heels. They couldn't run in high heels and get in the bunker fast enough before the flash.
You're thinking this way.
Yeah. His thinking is twisted.
No.
Is this a test?
No.
Did he get the check?
Well, it's kind of a test for us. Can we keep talking and saying nothing and still have it make sense?
That is a little bit like poetry, but actually what we've been doing is searching for the continuity. Somebody left the door open and the continuity got out again.
Slipped out while we were looking.
What if some free people do it? They're doing
all our continuity.
How many comedians?
There aren't any comedians.
How many comedians
are Wait a minute. Do you realize who we are? Do you know that we're famous Bay Area personalities?
I mean, we're not comedians. We're members of a giant church. That's the Church of the Subgenius, in case you've been dead for the last 10 years.
The two warring classes, never progressing except by hatred and conflict.
This is the Church of the Subgenius radio hour slack that's going on long after its due slot. Yes, spilling out over into other evenings from the wee hours of the morning. This show is assaulting all continuity.
He's in the church. He sent us money, actually.
He is out of it.
We're on the mailing list, actually, to all the major mail churches.
It's always like this for us, and
we can't help it.
And does this go down all the time?
Oh, 24 hours a day.
Every day.
That's right.
That's really exciting.
And you've just been fortunate enough to tune into only a small portion of it.
Are you carrying tape recorders?
Oh yeah.
8 or 9.
Yeah, several. At least.
And are you tape recorders now, or are you live?
Yes, that's the answer.
The opportunity to better stadium.
Jones?
Well, it's horrible. I could have predicted this.
I never thought it'd get this bad.
Yeah, a bunch of guys trapped in a tiny room trying to communicate with what's left of the world. Here are the shots in the background.
Your radio right now, you'll see is the power of the shell.
Going on and on.
Where between the disc
and the dissidents out on the street out here.
We're scared right now because we're here and you're there. It is so scary to be here alone with nothing but poor Bob Nelson.
Well, it's
with something that's not even there. It's getting more and more expensive all the time.
That's right. It's become like a nightmare or a dream.
Let's listen.
Okay.
Yes, we have radio shows in all major cities. In fact, we do most of them.
I know.
Yes, in January.
You have a voice that makes you seem like you're not real.
Don't
listen
to me,
Judge. Wait, yes?
Oh.
Hi.
Yeah, I want to get my van.
I've got a dog.
Okay, puzzling evidence of link between Nazis still in operation after World War
II. That's the dog's name.
Still unsolved murder of John F. Kennedy.
It's burned up like a match. Yes, that must have been the kitty from hell.
Sure was. No pan pots on him. Everything's full of bombs. Here we go.
Your minute after he's giving you instructions on how to survive.
You can't. This is listener-censored radio. And
special.
You send in your money, you have a shot at getting us off the air.
How does it get?
Didn't you have your $20 rate of poverty subscriptions for almost everybody?
Okay. No, I'm sorry. There is more. See, there's more coffee. There's more everything. Yeah, there's more comedy.
The poor little boat game can't have no coffee.
And there are more hints hidden inside us about the new show in January.
The first show.
And why people will pay $7.50 to get inside the Victoria Theater and what they'll see. If we have decided to actually do a show.
Yes. There's some colleagues out there trying to give their money.
$60 group and family subscription for those cults which sit around in large rooms. And for real rich people, you can set us $1 million a month.
Yes.
Fallout.
No.
What are you still doing out there? Well, anyway, you could call us at 848-KPFK.
I did call you.
He must have a helmet.
He called me.
Wait. Did you get one of his helmets?
Yeah, my phone's been ringing. I just picked it up.
Pentagon. A Pentagon.
Pentagon, sitter.
Keja.
Yeah, I got it.
Huh? Hello.
Keja.
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 Oh, right.
I've been in touch with the lady Keja station over in San Francisco.
Oh, I see.
Seems to me I have the right.
Wotan. Wotan.
KPFA?
A milk-white steed we offer thee. Wotan. Wotan. We have sacrificed. We have sacrificed unto thee. Wotan.
Yes.
A milk-white steed.
The wounded helmet ones are now filing out of the studio.
You killed him. He's dead.
No, I haven't had so much fun since we had the Libyan Hit Squad here as a guest.
Yeah, we ought to go have Sonny Barger do a lip lock on this guy's broom closet or something.
Hell's Angel. Wait, he's like gay?
Let's see if we can contact.
So what happened to the rest of the gang?
Oh my god.
We shut the door off and
shut themselves out there.
Yeah, right.
Well,
we sent them out to
doctor,
see whether it was safe enough for us to come
the
out
great,
and they don't look
well
at
here
all.
Not
so I think we're just going to have to stay in here another couple hours.
It's time for some more sound therapy.
I think.
See! Apparently, take a lot of these.
Bouncing off.
Bouncing off.
The normal listener, this could remove facial hair if you can manage to close it to your radio speaker.
You killed him. He's dead.
Well, caller, where were you when the war started?
Where was I?
Yes, and what did you have to do with starting the war?
I was sitting on the toilet in Poughkeepsie, Illinois.
Yeah, well.
The next thing I knew, I woke up, I was in North Berkeley.
You woke up.
Oh my God.
Where were you, and what were you doing when the war started?
Well, I was arranging books in my room.
Yes, well, fortunately, the books protected me from the initial blast damage.
Oh, my God, that's good.
They covered my body, and I was able to occupy the time I spent lying there reading a few of the dissertations of Epictetus.
The surviving good. Listeners could certainly be uplifted by that exciting... How many flashes a minute can you see from up there on your...
Well, since I looked at the first one, I can't see very much at all. You know, it's very nice of you fellas to try to comfort me and everything, but the radioactive rain is falling, and I've been kind of depressed ever since this entire affair started.
Well, we really have been trying to make light of the whole thing to try to cheer
up.
This is the post-nuke
here in the minute after show.
Yeah, this is the minute after show, and we're here to liven up those survivors who want to be livened up, and those who'd like to be dead, we'll help you kick right over. You know, whatever is your forte, five-te.
We're calling all the survivors.
It's so exciting to hear how way out there in the field.
It's sort of your post-nuke.
This is our nuclear war party, and we're having a fine old time tonight.
I see that you've got your nuclear war paint on in a red
we passed out the nuclear war.
How would you like to have been on that fatal plane?
I understand
you flew right into it.
It was the shining singing.
When you gotta go.
I would have been hungry. Everyone else would have been hungry.
Now you can hear the wind here the howling out there. We've been
having just fine here. The president's just flat and cold up here. No, it's just fine. No, no, okay. We'll put that away and go on to our next segment here.
We're rational people.
Right.
One more vote. You get it.
Hey, Bob, what's the status of your prophecy book?
Yes, well, you've got plenty of stinking bicycles there. I believe isn't Chico the town with 240 bicycle shops?
It doesn't make any sense, does it?
I don't know.
The president. Seems to have melted.
The president's just kind of flat. We pull him up here. It's just fine now. Nobody will get that
We'll put that away and go on to our next segment here in the war zone.
It's possible.
It's the beautiful dance of the officers as they twirl around the shiny floor just before they go out to die a horrible, senseless death. Yes, watch them kiss their fiancés and wives goodbye in a hopeless sense of dismay and depression.
You're listening to listener-censored radio.
We have a call-out now for any knight of the subgenius who is ready for the frog. Let him appear at this doorway before me.
He turned and saw a terrible beast who was very angry.
If he be a knight of the Blue Order,
he's got to move.
He's on the radio in New York.
Why does he on the radio in New York?
He's on the radio in New Mexico.
You're kidding me.
He's on the radio all over
because he's
on Puzzling Evidence Show.
You must bring me one of your daughters.
Yes, and God bless the president. Radioactive wife, too, and a little radioactive smoking gun. God bless all of them that brought this hell on earth to us all.
So the father set out and soon reached the city. He was sad to learn that there was very little money awaiting him, not even enough to buy the children's gifts.
Merry Christmas, Tiny Tim.
Tiny little salamanders.
Tiny
little
lizards.
No more.
All the little lizards.
I hope you're happy.
You know, kitties and dogs.
The boiled owls. The boiled cookies. Cabbage patch kids.
That's right. All gone. Nothing left but cockroaches. Field mice and scorpions. It was the nuclear winter.
No, negative on that.
No, there's plenty of room. Come on aboard.
Okay, there's a tentacle coming out of the cloud. A cloud?
Yes, I see a flashing light.
He's a very complicated figure, a very enigmatic figure. It's very puzzling.
Yeah,
go ahead.
Did you know,
just
for my walkman, was
there
really nuclear wars?
Yeah.
Oh!
Well, how do you like it, Hal? Hey, what's the roll window up there?
It's comfortable. I like it. We've got it all lined with shag carpeting. Now, this is what I call good taste.
Pass me another martini, okay?
All right, but easy on the butter.
You're back.
These things slide down real easy.
Yeah, I know. It's strange to think that they grow these shells. Mm-hmm. Boy, it's hard to drink them out of this tin cup, too.
I'm so glad you're back.
Well, we can't both
speak. You were out
going
there
to be
in the wilderness.
Light soon?
I'll survive. No more light left.
Bet you feel stupid, huh?
I really do.
Resistance is the basic force of the universe.
And when do you expect the full effect to hit you?
Anyway, I'd like to get off, and I'd like to also comment that,
yes, we all like to get off. That's the thing.
There are many high-lift devices in use today.
Yes, and if you don't have those pills, you can write to us. At box 1189, 2000 Center Street,
American
Prison, California, 94704.
I'm talking about it. Don't bother us with that nonsense anymore.
Let's take more and see what happens.
And the fluff girl
by
first, we'll go over the Vedantic scriptures for a few hours before we go on the air. Then a quick round of calisthenics and jogging in our special Bob warm-up suit in our Bob Nagin. And finally, a splash in the Bob pool. And
we've got an FCC license, and nothing's going to happen right around here.
Though there's one motor gone, still we must carry on, coming in on a wing and a prayer.
Yes, the show has come around to your side of the planet now.
Turn us all into statues of oleo, which melt with the piercing rays of the dawning, drowsy sun.
Well, we'll have to type up that sun now, because as soon as you mention those kinds of things, we have to start filling out reports and doing jobs.
That's right. Here we have a classroom resource program, Summary of Needs. This chart presents a recommended resource purchase plan based upon an analysis of materials listed in the resource inventory.
Now, if we're able to complete these resources, we can get this show going.
What were the two major factors which were considered, Doctor?
Air and heat this morning.
Wow. Yeah, it was the end.
You don't have to.
About an hour ago. We're pretty stupid, too, because, I mean, it was the end, and here we are. We've kept going.
Yeah.
Think somebody will tell us it's the end. No way.
Maybe we won't have to go to work tomorrow.
Wow, it's a great job, though. Look at the blood and scars.
Come on, Johnny. Let's have a drink.
Visitors are expected to bring their own electrodes.
L.A.?
L.A.?
Who?
L.A. Say who?
Who?
Yes, Yakutismo's 11, boblets, 9.
I'm afraid we're going to have to go to line number
we
2.
We saw the game.
Just pop those boblets into the oven and watch them swell up. They seem like they're alive, and they are. They're waving and weeping at you as you close the oven door on them forever.
Hello.
Yeah,
wait till we find out who the Pootangle is.
You want to hurt him where he lives, in his bank.
If we called Arkansas, you'd find people who want to hurt him real.
Okay, the Interocitor is tuned up, and off we go.
Take your boblets and place them in the oven on a greasy cookie sheet. Watch them wave their little hands and wink their little eyes in desperation and frustration. Then slam the glowing red hot heated oven door on their pitiful cry. Rated
R. Good morning, welcome to Doctors at Boblets at Dawn.
Okay, you failed the test. Is it? Well, it's still 5-1.
So far, I'm
doggy over kitty. Here, where the continuity struggles.
We're pulling down the property values of these poor animals.
That's right, caller, and you'll have to move into a cheaper and cheaper and cheaper animal. Soon you'll be living in a parakeet.
Okay, I'm wearing a parakeet.
Just picking your brain for the show.
Look how easily that flesh tears. They don't make them the way they used to.
No, they sure don't. These zombies are hard to use.
Yeah, I mean, don't blow off your job, man. You're free of all your responsibilities.
Exactly.
If
you can walk, you got slack, Jack. If you can talk, you should be dancing right now, fella.
Yes, dancing over the graves of all your fellow humans here in the ruins of your civilization.
Hey, man, everybody in Jeff Leppard is not dead.
They're all just a bunch of dust now. Along with your stereo.
Or Bill me.
Oh, no, it's another little tape recorder. It must be Funto calling.
Okay. Then Vega, the mystery caller, calls in and makes the people on the show sick.
Well, I'm glad I could get your
attention. You have our unqualified and undivided attention, sir. Please go on. We're listening
enough,
to exactly whatever it is that you have to tell us this morning.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, well, maybe if you put your little mouth hole a little closer to the phone and... Well, stop making a little sucking motion on the phone and just speak.
speak a little bit louder, thousands and thousands, or literally tens of listeners at least, will hear you.
But some of them only want to have the proper ignition.
Doesn't work for me, but I do it anyway.
It's not working for me.
Air and time. How do they interact with you?
We've tried
time,
and we've tried the air, and we have nothing left but time.
Hey, where are you guys? I got right over here.
Yeah, come on. Can't you see us? We're waving. Yeah.
Over here.
Over near that big pile of smoking rock.
Yeah. Have we got the
fix on the interoperative? Yes, he's about to fire a green flare from the surface. You might be able to see it. Check out
I'm not sure that our viewers at home are aware of how this device works.
I'm sorry you've been blinded. How thoughtless of me. I keep forgetting.
What are you talking about?
It's so hard to tell.
Camera. Nobody at home saw it.
He might still be able to see the glow through his clothes.
He had our special glasses on. He was at South Africa.
It was to know that every nuclear weapon on Earth was detonated all at once by a randomly generated charged car bomb. It was a garage door from a car.
You might kind of
450,000 little voices in Oakland.
Radio.
We got all of those little voices, all the same. Louder and louder and louder.
I walk down Shattuck Avenue and I see a blue glow of light surrounding the buildings closing your station.
Here we're going to NB21R to show you quickly where we are talking about.
Look at that lovely blue ring. Kind of soothing. Peaceful.
Yeah, like an old movie.
Looks like a nice place.
My ear.
Kind of spot you'd like to raise your
kids. Look, there's some alien in this
bathroom. About an inch off the floor. Yes, they're pouring in from all points of the compass.
Yes.
From every part of this old solar system, they're coming in and parking their skyships on the roof of our own radio station. And even aliens have no privacy. They don't know that we're peeping in on them with our super snooper eye from all the way across the galaxy. It's like they say, too many kooks spoil the brothel. And look at our switchboard. It's lighting up like a Christmas tree.
There's something wrong.
Our switchboard is lighting up like a Christmas tree. In fact, I believe I am looking at
a Christmas
tree.
Who are you? Why are you away?
But I think we should make an exception this time. Perhaps we should continue.
I think we should make a very special exception of this individual. His charge box removed from the chip.
The coffee appears,
but those guys didn't even wash their Atari. We're not ready for nothing that's not ready.
Dolls the call.
The sheep in a slippery stream, and while in the swamp, bongs the gongs of a throng of frogs.
The best thing to do with the used religion is to sell it. Stop the
list. See high price.
Kill the car.
Hello? So where are all the lights
right here, sir?
Lights and colors?
Lively fellows.
Oh, lively fellows. I'm afraid we had to reinter them. They were only exhumed for our night of horror last week, and now they've had to go back to the subterranean tomb.
Yes. Okay, strap the Kasners to the transmitter.
Okay, Kasner strap.
Okay, now secure the heads.
They are all
heads secured. Heads
all
right.
A different appearance.
Set the setting for the dial for N, the other dial for P. We're taking the show to the head.
Here we go again. Whoa!
They cut us off. Those impudent swine. Now it's time for our listeners to take their winky dink crayon and draw a garish pink line on the radio.
Show canceled. Restart. Show canceled. Restart.
Now it looks he's coming around.
I feel better now. I'll just swim away from the building.
Come back here with that boy.
I'll make the show funny someday. Hello, man. Good morning, caller. How do you feel about this historic moment? It's hard to hold this end of the world up.
No, this microphone's red hot.
I can't hold the show up much longer, caller.
And we were seeing this blue glow of light pulsating and expanding rhythmically out into the night sky, painting the clouds with its luminescence. All the consciousnesses of the subgenii are coalescing in this very one moment. It's coming from Presto Prince also. It's spreading to the exclusive store and the toy store. And blue, the windows are filled with blue light.
And now our police are going nuts outside. They're close. They're... I've never seen so many Dallas police in one place.
Hey, I only eat crayons because they don't provide anything else to eat on this show. These crayons, they don't taste bad. If you eat them, if you drink them, you'd have a little drop.
But that's for the eggheads and the bubble dome boys, not for us normals to consider. These little creatures are rather interesting because they swim up the urinary tracts of men who are bathing in the stream and inflate their body, which is covered with red-hot spikes. And, well, it's not a pretty sight. There's missionaries down there. It's, you know, you may think I'm making this up. It's true. But the fact is that once these spikes are inflated, according to certain missionaries in the area, there's nothing to do but, well, it's but removal of the male organ, you know.
And then where do they put that part?
Well, they throw it back in the river.
Right, the one with the big eyebrows.
13. Okay, I'm here. Number 666. The operating contest will begin in 14 minutes. A little bit early to be talking about such private nuisances.
All I'm saying is that even in fresh water, even in an old scummy pond where you might think you're perfectly safe, you never know what old dame nature is going to have slither up into the very heart of your being.
Yeah,
so you've got to be ready. You've got to be prepared. You've got to be awake all the time and alert and ready.
Is that why you wear that little net thing?
Well, gee, I'm glad you noticed after all this time. It's made by Mr. Robert in San Francisco. And look at these beautiful rhinestones. There's one on this side, and this one on the other side is my birthstone. It's an opal, and this is a Buick Simca. All right, well, now it's getting time to bring out our little donkey friend.
A little tiny Hinto donkey friend.
He's really cute, isn't he? It's a shame we have to do what we have
Hinto
to do.
Hinto stops, and Hinto starts.
Doug, I don't think you should be playing with those 9-pound spiders.
Put that spider down.
They're perfectly harmless.
Hey, look at this. Look what's on the bottom of these things.
Well, I'm sorry. I guess I must have been reading out of the wrong book. Not supposed to have
done it. Stop him. He's getting away.
When suddenly a dark cloud came over the sun and they pricked their fingers on
this was supposed to be a friend. Oh, no. He was in love.
God, this is amazing. I want to get one of those spiders to bite me, too. Who would have ever thought that after the war would have been so much fun? It's kind of relaxing. Look at that beautiful sunset. So many colors, like a thousand volcanoes coloring the atmosphere.
Then take me.
What a mutual blast.
But that's because in those primitive times, they could not desternutate.
They didn't want to.
Work better if you plug them in.
Their noses swelled up to the size of golf balls, and finally they were teed off and left our galaxy for greener pastures on the other side of the universe.
This is the ghost of Bob Marley, man.
Oh, no.
You've got a real alien show.
These space monsters are about to let us get away with a show this dumb.
It's too late to turn back now.
But why bother calling this show? You could call somebody that's asleep right now.
For the case.
Sure, just pick any number in the phone book and call that number and say, "Oh, hi, I'm sorry I woke you up, but the Church of the Subgenius radio hour is on now, and you should be listening to it."
Unambitious.
And, you know, if you do this to people you don't know, then you just dial any number.
That carries a garish, lurid, and quite linear structure beneath the disguise of this weird part of the show.
We'll have lots more listeners.
Then at Larry's and Curly's bookstore, we're going to have a large dismembering and defenestrating.
These shows are all just like this show, but the big show...
Oh,
you?
Yes, they are. Don't you contradict me, young man.
Right.
Well, you're just not listening enough. Put out your ear antennas and listen to the microphone.
Listener, which equipment will the AFT load center circuit breaker secure when pulled?
Another rival call.
Yeah, the so-called pencil bombs that were planted in the pockets of almost every American by the treacherous and nasty enemy. Yes, the Empire of Evil.
And the KGB were calling these pocket bombs.
We heard a rumor that...
Yeah, right. The little gods who wear their skeletons on the outside. They'll have all the church here they need come 1998, my friends. Oh,
yeah, some of them aren't willing to wait.
That's right.
Indeed.
When he's handed a big, bright, shiny pill, a pure subgenius laughs at a glass of water. He laughs through a glass of water. In fact, he laughs while chewing soda crackers and drinking water and rubbing his stomach and patting his head if he's given the right kind of pill.
And there's the famous click. As you know, your master copy side A is off.
Go to side B, unless, of course, you've used side B in some other Wotan session long ago. Now all the Wotan trucks and tanks are lining up because it's time to turn things again. By shooting at the other band, Wotan bands and destroying their stages and sets, playing louder than everybody else, and singing the songs and having the songs written down and actually choreographed, and thousands of dancers come out and dance around and whiz around the stage, and the Wotan band goes crazy, flings itself off into the stage, a frenzy dance of death. All the way down.
In the event of emergency, when there's a blackout or any kind of PG&E inspired blackout, you know, the church will deliver water to you and climb your stairs even if you have an elevator that's out.
I drink soda.
Wow. Yeah. Right.
They will deliver.
Wow. Yeah.
They deliver.
There is no good or bad.
Do they deliver it like the milkman?
No right or wrong.
But do they deliver it like the milkman does?
Yeah.
Huh? Come on, man. Answer me.
Yes, they do deliver.
Okay.
They do deliver.
Now,
Satan will deliver.
Do you have a coupon for the Sunday paper?
Yes, okay. That's redeemable at any satanic representative, Beelzebub, Lucifer.
How do you summon these people to your
any kind of Asmodeus,
Astaroth. Is that the Satan alert button? Been activated?
I don't know. I guess
Does that mean there's a demon in your house?
Yeah.
It does?
I don't know. I don't know what. It seems like they're picking up the pieces of the girl that was on that mattress.
And what are they going to do with it? Put it back together?
Oh, they're slurping. Oh, my God. They're eating her.
Oh, wow. Ask them if they need any barbecue
sauce. Oh, God. We'll give black guys some movie.
Man, they're making me hungry.
Yeah, I know.
Man.
That's just...
Let me get a bite.
You know, I got to go to Carl's Jr. now.
Me too. Get a flame broil. Yeah. You know?
Yeah.
If it ain't all over the place.
Yeah. I know.
Oh, they're scraping it up now?
No, I can't. Yeah.
This is getting every last piece.
I don't care. I want my burger, damn it. They're behind people smashing the place ahead.
Oh, so they're like the Who in a motel room.
Yeah, I know. They're breaking the place apart. I need my burger. I don't care.
Huh. Well, I still wanted a piece of that, you know?
You know,
geez.
Pretty delicious. It sounds pretty good to me.
I mean, I want some. where can I get some?
Yeah, I don't know. Well, we just got to keep listening. Maybe the ads will come on again.
I see.
I don't know, because, it's a weird show. You know, there might be like an ad for...
Yeah, well, I got forever.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
That is, of course.
Yeah.
You know, I've been like, eyeballing the cops down the street, but they've been eyeballing me, so...
Yeah.
I don't know. I think they got demons in them.
You know?
It's called... I don't know. They got red lights, And they bind you.
Uh-huh.
They can take away your vision.
Oh, yeah.
And they can do whatever they want once they have you in submission.
That's right. They get control of you subtly and very gradually. You don't even know.
But they say they're your friend.
Yeah, exactly.
So they must be demons.
I know. They act like really like you.
Because they speak in black and white.
And, yeah, and, you know, those bad guys over there, you know, they're really evil. And, but me,
you're
going to
have a new husband.
Huh.
Come on down here. Is this plaguing every town?
Yeah. It's all over. It's clearly all pervasive because of the internet.
Are some places worse than others?
This is not just emotionalism. I think things are worse than others.
Well, you know, there's a large... very, very large congregation of them up north here in Vallejo.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. And then you go further as far as...
You're trapped.
Him and I used to fight all the time, and you could just... the devil and his
fight. Yep, that's what happened.
How long have you been this way? It's all
wrong. They kick in your door and they come inside.
How do you know he's demon possessed or was?
How do I know?
Because the church I went to, and he said there wasn't nothing to it. You're just lying. And I said, fight him to go to church and do what's right. And he told me tonight that there wasn't, he wasn't demon possessed and coming down there tonight. He said there wasn't nothing to it.
He
said there was nothing to it. He's finding out tonight.
Okay, but I got the perception of that he's on the airwaves. So I'm good.
But you feel good now?
Yeah.
It's gone. Put your hands up and praise the Lord with me, everybody. Let's say thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. And you're going to be all right now?
Yeah.
Everybody stand and let's praise the Lord for his goodness. Stand and let's praise God for his goodness. Now we're going to have a happy family here. We're going to have a happy couple. There comes their little girl. She wonders what's happened to Daddy now. All right, honey, you're going to have a new couple. Everybody, let's give Jesus a big hand.
I am now talking. I have the power to send you home by Christmas. But it's not on Trans World Airlines. Thank you.
It is a nasty, nasty world out there. Confusing, messy, irregular, difficult to understand world out there. But sometimes there's a ray of hope, there's a little bit of light. Makes you think things aren't as bad as they seem. Like recently in Kenya, when the stolen Quranic tuna was recovered. A tuna caught off the coast of Kenya that appeared to have a Quranic verse on its side has been recovered after somebody stole it from a government fisheries office in Mombasa, where it was being stored. Whether the Arabic inscription, which appeared to say, "You are the best provider," was natural or a hoax remains the subject of curious debate. Still, some imams in Kenya mosques have preached about the fish, which they see as a sign from God. Offers to buy the 5-pound fish, which was caught last weekend by a fisherman named Saeed Ali, have topped $150. In Kenya, a tuna that size usually goes for about $5. Here in America, a sinkhole swallowed a man in Sacramento, out in Alta, actually. A giant sinkhole that swallowed an Alta man in his living room Friday night was still growing Sunday, precluding rescuers from recovering the victim. Jason Chalou, 32, was sitting in his home. He's just sitting there in his home. And then he suddenly was buried under 8 feet of debris. The hole appeared suddenly about 9:30 p.m. on the floor of the home in Alta. The victim was relaxing in his living room and reportedly heard creaking noises. He sprang up and began to move across the room just as the floor opened beneath him. From what we understand, it was instantaneous. Not a whole lot you can do. Just north of Interstate 80 up there in the Sierra Nevada Mountains, about 25 miles east of Auburn. So 100 people go up and start investigating the hole where the guy disappeared. A mine collapse is probably the likely cause of the tragedy. By Sunday afternoon, the hole had doubled in size to 30 feet by 20 feet and was still growing. The hole, in fact, had spread beyond some of the load-bearing walls of the home, leading the recovery team to conclude the home must be demolished before they can go back in. In what? It's demolished. Otherwise, they have the risk of the house collapsing on top of them during the very recovery effort. A second sinkhole also opened up 50 feet away from one side of the house. But officials don't know if the two holes are connected underground.
Yeah, I know.
I know. It's tough. It is tough. Girl is well after swallowing spoon. Dead lizard triggers mass recall of Japanese potato chips. Chinese live in fear of 8 things, says report. A lot of folks being naked lately. In Oakland, a carpenter who keeps his clothes clean by working in the nude was arrested after a client returned home early and found him in the building, or rather found him building bookcases in the buff. If you want to hire him, Percy Honeyball, 50, was charged with misdemeanor indecent exposure last week for the October incident. He told officers he stripped before crawling into the client's house to do electrical work because he didn't want to soil his clothes. He claims it gives him a better range of motion. And of course, a man who spent 5 hours naked in Hayward, stuck in the chimney of his stepmother's home, was arrested on under the suspicion of being under the influence of drugs. Michael Urbano, 23, locked himself out of the house early Saturday morning and decided to get back in the house, swinging on a cable TV wire and dropping it down the chimney. But the wire broke, Urbano fell, got stuck 3/4 of the way down. He was freed when a firefighter pushed him to safety, naked as a jaybird. He told us he took his clothes off because there'd be less friction going down the chute. We did find his clothes, so that part checked out. That was about 6:15 a.m. Saturday. A neighbor heard faint, distressing calls since about 2:30 a.m. and called the police 4.5 hours later. By the way, in India, a school textbook used in Western Rajasthan state compares housewives with donkeys and says the animals are better companions and more loyal. The book was approved by the state's governing Hindu nationalist Janata Party and set off protests by the party's women. Yes, and in Germany, prison for a man 73 who killed his fiance, who was 84. The retired miner was sentenced to 8 years and 9 months in prison for killing his 84-year-old fiance with a homemade bomb. He used steel wool, nails, and nitrogen and other substances to make the bomb, which he hurled at the woman on a street. She was set on fire by the blast and died of her injuries 3 months later. The court found that the man was convinced his fiance had been cheating on him. Now this one I thought was pretty incredible. The hiker on a scenic hillside overlooking the Pacific Ocean who found a skeletal remain of a man inside a treehouse where the man had apparently been living. Investigators said Thursday the body may have been there for more than a year. The body was found April 20th by a hiker who strayed off Land's End Trail in San Francisco's western edge to clean up trash. The treehouse consisted of a 3x7-foot platform of branches intricately woven into the lower limbs of a cypress tree, including sunshades to prevent the occupant from being blinded, hit by the wind. Now, it says here that the man was Frank Cruz, who had been born October 7th, 1943. So we called and found out that Frank Cruz's siblings have been searching for their brother for more than 2 decades. Authorities found the identification and hooked up to Guam, asked for help in identifying the body. His sister, Chris Castro, 64, lives in Ego, northern Guam. She contacted the San Francisco Medical Examiner's office after reading about the discovery. None of his relatives have heard from this Mr. Frank Cruz since 84 when he was working as a pipe fitter in the Naval Shipyard. Amazing. To me. Maybe not to you. For years, various three thinkers among us have been looking at the work on the problem of how to unload the hooch when parents or teachers or law enforcement officers close in. To this end, immeasurable amounts of drugs have been swallowed and flushed and fed to witless mutts inside Little Debbie snack cakes. But not until the night of June 24th had the distinguished practice seen its highest expression. There it goes. That evening, Michael Ray Sullivan and Joseph Calvin Seidel, two Kentucky-based entrepreneurs, were pulled off the road by the police near Kingdom City, Missouri, and forced to unveil for the first time their handmade cigarette lighter-powered driver-activated stash rocket. According to an affidavit by Special Agent Pete Mouse of the Drug Enforcement Administration, Sullivan and Seidel's design, which was observed in the trunk of Sullivan's 1990 Ford Thunderbird, consisted of a hobby-style rocket that was controlled by an elaborate system of ropes and pulleys that lifted the rocket from a prone to upright position upon the opening of the car's trunk. The rocket was 3 to 4 feet long and 3 to 4 inches in diameter, was connected via a series of wires to the police. The police say they drew their power from the cigarette pipe to a homemade switch in the front of the car. Its payload consisted of 2 gallon-sized Ziploc bags that contained roughly 2 pounds, or 917 grams of methamphetamine. Because the rocket was not successfully launched on the evening of the 24th, experts can only theorize that it was meant to be an escape pod for illegal contraband. But those theories do appear to be scientifically sound. As a spokesman for the U.S. Attorney's Office of Kansas City said, when you assess the available data, they did have the meth inside the rocket, and it could be launched from inside the car. Here you go, folks. The new world is here. It's here now. It's here now. The hormone oxytocin, which plays a role in childbirth, breastfeeding, orgasm, and feelings of love, is usually thought to have a happy set of responsibilities within the body. But a new study suggests the hormone could be put to more sinister uses. According to a paper published in June in the interest of, the June issue of Nature, a research team at the University of Zurich has determined that a nasal spray containing oxytocin can be used to make human subjects more trusting. In the study, 128 male participants played several rounds of a game borrowed from the economic and social behavior theory. The game essentially offers rewards to investors who are willing to temporarily entrust some or all of their money to an anonymous trustee. Almost half the investors, who took 3 puffs per nostril of the oxytocin spray, transferred all of their money to unseen trustees, whereas only a quarter of those who inhaled the placebo went that far after throwing up. Oxytocin doesn't make you nicer or more optimistic or more willing to gamble. It causes a substantial increase in trusting behavior after throwing up. Crossfield grudgingly allows that his team's research could one day be applied to exploit people. But for the time being, salesmen, politicians, and Lotharios look to increase their appearance of trustworthiness will have a hard time gaining much benefit from any finding. At this point, you'd have to use the nasal spray, so you really need the consent of the other person, which requires a degree of trust in the first place. Moreover, the effects only last a few minutes, hardly long enough to negotiate a contract for someone's soul. Oh, I don't know. You know, if you have enough two-dimensional food, I don't know if you really need that. The urine-powered battery. Two-dimensional food really is like Michael Pippen.
Everything is food, of course. Milk, beer.
All right. What are the 8 things that Chinese people live in fear of?
Tea, coffee, cannabis sativa.
Well, there's a building collapse by shoddy workmanship, or poisoned by a toxic beer served at a wedding banquet. The other 7 recently in the by China in a popular Chinese website. Sohu.com are official corruption, retrenchment, soaring health costs, exorbitant property prices, uncertainties after retirement, rising university fees, and unpredictability of business ventures.
Make me cry.
Yes, I'm afraid so.
I want to know about the tipping point of the guy who was buried in his own trash. What was the trash? Was it toilet paper, books, videotapes? You know, the guy that was crushed by his own stuff.
It was his house. His whole house.
His whole house?
Collapsed in on him instantaneously. And they never got him out.
So it was the roof? No. I thought he was found after a while.
All right.
This was a sudden thing.
Yeah, this happened very quickly. Before he could even say, wait, the show.
Oh, wait. I know, I've got to listen to the show more. House don't collapse in on me. Well, I know the feeling. But my house is old enough since 89. But, of course, when we're in the big house, like...
Or if you've done too much coffee, they put you in Maxwell House.
Yeah.
that's right, Dan. You don't get to see anything or anybody.
For a long time.
I've seen grown men pull their own heads up and go to into Maxwell. Amnesty International tried to shut it down. Maxwell House, what do they call it? Starbucks. Declared that they had the right to hold people against their will. Camps, what they call recaptivation camps. And Starbucks personnel let the so-called customers out of their cages in the beginning of the day and allowed them to roam for 45 minutes. That was the only exercise they had. And the only food they had was Starbucks low foam decaf vegan lattes. For months. And people just stand by. They just look at it. They say, hey, that's Starbucks. That's what you get to do.
This is impossible. Oh.
Uh-huh. There you go.
Right.
Yes, good morning. It's Doctors at Dawn. What you're talking about here is Doctors for Extreme Prejudice, our guest here tonight in the studio, down here by the beach. Yes, for the first time, Doctors for Extreme Prejudice hits the West Coast.
Look at that
again this year.
Yes.
And when the doctors get together, they like to relax with a few shots and a few shots.
Yes, a few shots and a few shots.
It's all right, doctor. You'll be okay.
Holy Bob.
That's just another fine doctor for Bob, all puffed up and swollen with the sound of rant.
Yeah.
Doug, did you gas the show up?
No, I don't think I did. I better check.
Okay, I've got my credit card, so I'm going to go gas it up while you guys clean the windshields.
Okay, get some Raisin Bran, okay, and some
okay.
Big Newtons and stuff.
All right.
Now we're ready to go to camera 3 and the closest shot of this scary operation which we've been able to see this morning.
And here are the little tree frogs that used to inhabit the island and came. Oh, come on, get them off me.
Hey,
those are weird.
Hey, you want to get those frogs
off?
They're
jumping all over the bathroom.
Get those frogs off.
Where's
Nelson,
my torch?
Ouch.
How do I get out of here?
This is sticky.
I'm going to the other end of the house.
Wait, you got the wrong show, dog.
Oh, this isn't the Bolivian show?
No.
Oh, this is the Oakland show.
Yeah,
right. Berkeley show.
The Berkeley show, right. Take the frogs off.
No frogs here.
No, you need muggers and police cars.
These are not good operating conditions here on the football field with all these dogs crowding around the table, but they get whatever's left over, and that's what we call the eco balance of nature.
I'll try to wake up and talk.
Hey, Doug, you want to give me the key so I can get the tank unlocked?
Do we use keys in this show?
Well, if you want me to fuel up the show.
I guess so. I guess we better use
them. Well, I have a key. Tonight's show is going to various scary parts of the world. We're going to the wrong right side of the Yakutizma Perception Center, where people are going to stretch out their little naval ice stage fields, and we're going to look for Bobbions in a Gargamel sound chamber. And
not for no one, neither.
We'll take the show back to the far other side of the extent of where we haven't been yet.
Gary, did you bring your law firm?
Dude, it's right here in my teeth.
Okay, break it out. Well, break out what you can. Let's get them to signing these papers. Hurry up. Stang's not going to find out before we get them all signed.
This says Stang has to be terminated with extreme prejudice.
Stang doesn't know about that yet. We're still signing the papers.
Sign over there.
Now, could you sign this piece of
paper? Okay, now, over there. Okay.
Will you have your wife sign this piece, please?
Okay. Your children need to make their marks here and here.
And your pets will have to sign here.
And
please.
The house. Here are the papers for the house.
Your cars have to sign here, please.
Yes. Someone else has to sign in all three of these places.
Which finds itself or all holdings in and out of the Western Hemisphere have to sign here.
Our repossessing. Okay. This is the final agreement. It says, I, the inside, I am staying in return for the 2/3 of my soul back from the elder bankers, hereby give the church to the bank. And so right here. And right here. Yeah, okay.
And here,
chapter
3.
Okay, that's the paper that you guys.
getting his chance.
We can't wake him up in the middle of the night and take his church away with his kids sleeping and his wife
clothes on. She'll be out in the
street. I'm sorry, he's just lost it.
I mean, come on,
just took the church away from him. The church no longer belongs to him.
The way I see it,
I got two thirds of the book in the mail myself.
Look, here's Stan calling in to tell us he wants his church back.
Thank you. Hello, this is Stan. Where's Bob?
Well, you don't have to worry about Bob because there's a new church.
Oh, is this time control?
So here is your future, Wiz's past, on your video screen. You can see the bad things that happened in 1984 and the good things that will be happening in 1985 when your new religion is being sold. Sorry.
No.
Sorry.
Oh, okay.
No, what do you think they're going to think of when they hear this show back there, the Combas in their little huts?
Well,
they're going to drive away from those little huts. They're going to
get in their Toyota
mad.
Trucks and just drive away. Hello, caller.
I just walked in.
Well, so did we. Well, I run the show from the left side of your brain.
Okay, here, and we'll unplug the right side.
It's true, the show stumbled on its own 1.5.
Come on, doctor, this man's bleeding to death.
Okay, it's all better now.
No, I'm not even listening to your show.
Good.
Well, we can't stay to be on your show because we have another listener.
We're picking up the vibration.
You are not.
Another dead radio station.
Bolivia.
Yeah, we can test station. It bounces off.
Fox in Bolivia.
Oh, no, not that. I can't.
Hey, Fram.
Sorry. We didn't mean to bring up Gabro Fram.
Drop the sacred name of Gabro Fram.
Not on the girl.
But this is, don't you think this is kind of incestuous, you know, a radio talk show, calling a radio talk show, I mean.
Hello, caller.
I just walked in.
Well, so did we.
No.
What program is this?
How did we get here?
We found the show in progress and nobody's running it.
Did you have the keys? Where's my car? Give me my car back, caller. I want to go home.
And we either deprogram them or teach them to say or kill me.
Here's that deprogramming going on right now. The battle between churches continues.
Well, that's what churches are for. Okay.
This is a message for world peace. Oops.
She was nobody knows anybody better than Rockness.
Yeah, but who knows Willie best?
Yes, we know Willie best.
Yeah. Yeah, you got another caller, so I'm going to sign off.
Okay, well, thank you. Yes.
Bye.
Good night.
And what about the giant sea otters?
Well, we thought we'd work on them starting Thursday.
And the recombinant DNA horseshoe crabs, what about them?
We'll just have to fold them up and use them next year.
And what about the Marin County Liberation Front? Are they still operating?
We may hear from them later.
I'm the one who plastered all the notices about the Subgenius World Convention Revival.
Who's made a big noise about wanting to know the truth?
So what? You're the zombie. Good.
No. I'm not a zombie. I'm
a zombie?
A zombie?
No.
Zombie. That's all we ever hear of
you. You see, John, this is how things go on the Subgenius Hour, which is not quite a show, but
yes,
is definitely
less than an hour.
Less than a minute. Well, thank you. We have the fourth one on your show.
Yes, it's a good fight.
Okay, it's all better now.
That's
it.
Hey, can you handle it, Bob?
What should I do with the rest of my life?
Up there. What's going on here?
You're floating around the room.
Caller, you've got
to help us. So we do have a chance to cleave unto Bob. Don't you think? Here we go.
Whoa!
All babies come from their mother. You too.
Can we do that again?
Methods terminated.
Yes,
it's a radio station that's so popular that other radio stations are calling, ladies and gentlemen.
Well,
somebody doesn't take it.
And the head of the oil, well, not exactly head, but as coordinator.
Have you got this in writing?
Look, since I'm the coordinator, the first Hayward system chemical attack mentality, whether or not you want to admit it,
He'll stay the same volume.
Well, the guy just a little one tiny caller.
Your contribution has been a terrific success.
You're talking to the law firm of Gabrogfrang.
This church is under amateurization and post-chapter 15 bankruptcy takeover.
The whole point of this is I'm trying to get the first Heward Fifth Temple of Sacramentality on the map.
Well, you got it on the air.
We're just trying to figure out exactly what happened, and all I know is that the Exus came down and said, well, here's the money for your show, and here's the Exus now.
I wish your parents would have used birth control, you mother...
Message terminated.
Well, we can only hope that you follow the instructions and edit your show and send it to Fuzzly Nevins.
I mean, you
so it can be distributed in the scientific Fuzzly Nevins network of tape.
Hova 1.
Your contribution is helpful.
And we took over.
They made me do it.
And we locked him up.
Oh,
and that tiny scared Bob Nielsen is dying.
Okay.
A little lower to the left.
Oh, that's a lot better.
Yes,
I didn't think there was anything in there, but I'm surprised, actually.
Save me, Bob Dobbs!
Bob Dobbs can save Bob Nelson now.
Oh, thank you, Dobbs.
What we need is someone to take this church off our hands is what we need.
Okay, what's your church and what's your name?
First Church of the Good Discount, House of Faith.
Hey, that's my church.
That's your church? Hello?
This is a true story.
You're giving the church away?
No, we're actually...
You're man enough to take it.
Oh, well, what if you give it away, what are you people going to do?
Well, we're going to do something fun.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, we're going to quit working for Dobbs.
We're going to go to Green Hill to get Glanskate.
That's right.
Part of the plan, they'll come up, and there will be the sickening and healing.
What happened to all the doctors? What happened to the exploding golf ball?
What happened to the patient that caught fire on the table?
Yes, this is Reverend Carousel's trip.
Well, listen, the phones are ringing off the wall, and we'd like to help you out, but honestly, we're just going to have to turn your tape off because...
President Nixon is on line 3, Dr. Puzzling Evidence, and please pick up line 3.
Okay. Well, thank you.
Hello, this is Dan White.
Once you're in, you can
I come to your convention and get my head launched?
Yes, sir.
Oh, it's just a funny show, really.
Yes, it's a funny show. Sure.
Hello, tiny little caller.
Hello.
Wow, I don't believe it. This is actually a live show.
No, it's just a tape.
It's all tape.
Oh, my God. The tape set at the wrong speed.
Here you kind of crazy.
Oh, you mean you called in without finding out what you were calling?
Oh, I knew it was the Church of Subgenius because I'm a member. But,
you remember?
You
what do you
remember?
Yeah, what do you remember?
Oh, you've changed the name.
Oh, right. Okay,
yes,
go ahead.
Well, it's a new church, and it's a whole new story, and...
You're not the white-haired guy that's on all the time.
And before that, it gets weird, because then there comes the age of giant underwater scorpions and wiggly-oogly things wiggling through the primeval muck.
Boy, we pass them on with
because
the
we don't get up on that chart without enough of them.
In fact, any subgenius can chew up any denomination money and pass what he wants onto the show.
And they often do.
Yes, they do.
In places you've never imagined. And with things that you can't believe.
Well, we know where we usually pass things from, don't we?
Yes, we do.
From Bob and two others.
I wanted to explain something. I tuned in my radio a few minutes ago.
And sign here.
Towards the end of KPFA, and there you
go. Sign
here,
please. Sign over here, please.
Okay, that's right. We have to sign things. Lots of paperwork involved.
You have to sign.
Yeah. 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 Okay.
We got to the year here that it takes at least two groups of your house to keep the job.
I exist because the world's in my
telephone, yes.
Well, actually, the church only exists because we have the paperwork on it right here.
You want the church, sir or madam, whoever.
Sign here, please. Thank you.
My mouth works, therefore I am.
Well, I think I'm going to go out and stoke up the old wood fire. I'll be back in just a few minutes with some tips on your futures
on
Sardinia.
Bogus live stuff and go out on the roof, boy.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Huh?
Kiln fired an edible 24-calorie silver. Never before in human history is the Polk McKinley Hardy Coolidge Dobbs Mint, not a U.S. government body, commissioned such a rarity.
Delicious and crackling with a cooked skin of prepared edible material.
I think about it.
I think about it.
I think I'll have one right now.
Oh, I'll bet you have.
They grow into the same kind of animal.
He says he knows you, Doctor.
I want to come over there.
Turn on the monitor over here and see exactly who that is that's calling.
Can you see me?
Yes, we see you, and it's disgusting.
And I'm bringing the mirror close to my nose.
You're off on a tangent. Your values
Do you know who you're listening to?
Yes.
Which is the new voice?
People like your mother.
The new voice is the last voice that I heard.
Have human babies.
That does make sense.
There's the new voice again.
Must be one of those sub-genie hierarchical figures.
He knows all the passwords and the secret jokes, so let's send him a new cartoon by Snang.
Which one?
Which one? It's either, I think it's, I'm going to take a wild guess. It's Pope Meyer.
That's pretty wild.
That's pretty wild.
South.
Go south. It's Terry Thornley.
No, yes, not yes. Farther south.
Farther south.
Farther south and out of the country.
Oh, it's Robert Zesko?
Yes.
For the info. You know, the same old people. Go to the London Grill. We'll be doing our show from there.
You will?
Yeah.
On Friday night, your show's going to be from there?
Yeah, it's going to be from the London Grill in Santa Cruz on Friday night. It's going to be a remote.
Whopper station like invented to
if I go all the way down there, you guys aren't there. I'll laugh just as
I guarantee, you find the London Grill in Santa Cruz. We will be broadcasting from there on Friday.
And don't you do anything but bow your head and kiss your fanny that you even know about it.
You got the little white stuff you put on your nose so it doesn't chip here.
Are you pro capital?
That's the white stuff you put in your nose. I want the white stuff you put on your nose. Amateur capital punishment or kill me. Do you think capitals ought to be punished, Dr. Gabriel Graham?
Not much, but I guess it's a story.
Well, you can always get your parents to call in.
Miniature puterine reproductions authenticated by the World Court at The Hague and sent to you in moisture-resistant styrofoam chests of the front door letter slots of the subgenius 36 most beloved characters.
Don't blow into the microphone, young man, if you wish to receive a beautiful Hummel figurine which revolves on its ceramic base and plays the immortal Lara's theme from Dr. Zhivago.
Yes, a special blue ribbon advisory panel will ensure that the Foundation's Council certificate and inscribed insignias approved by Dobbs, Master of Heralds, before the application deadline.
No way. Explain to me, for the potential guests on this show.
Well, we are the potential guests.
So wait a minute. What we've got to do is concentrate on the potential guests, and you can stay with us for right now. Now, Doctor, I think we should return to the basic finances of the church and just who owns the church and what we can do with what's left of the church.
Right. Well, Ivan Stang no longer owns the church. Bob still has the foundation, but we've got papers on that.
All right. Hold on. Wait a minute. What we also can talk about, of course, is what we can do with the church now that what's left is still here and breathing.
Well, we could give it away, or we could just let someone take the church.
See, what
for
I think
a spin
is that people don't
it
realize that the church takes two rooms to keep and grow in your house.
At least two.
And the maintenance involved takes up most of the week anyway.
And it does not run on unleaded, I'm sorry. So,
made a big noise about
calling in
to
and saying you want the church. If you don't have at least two good-sized rooms in your house, yes, at least two good-sized rooms and a lot of money.
And a lot of
and neighbors that don't mind Wotan showing up in the middle of the night.
Right, and you need stamps and gummage.
What? Get the idea?
Or kill me! Now!
And the guy, it got to the point where the guy he was bothering pulled out a .32 and let him have it. And at which point, the bullet hit him square in the chest and went through his lung and came out his back. But instead of falling on the ground, he walked back in the bar and ordered a drink.
Get the idea?
Or kill me! Now! Now!
Why not?
Let's have a body count.
No.
Let's have a body count. None dead, it's a miracle, friends, it's a miracle above. Praise Bob! Praise Bob! Praise Bob! Praise Bob!
There are only two ways.
Stamps and gummage.
Yes, lots of stamps and gummage.
That. Would you sign here, please?
Okay, sign here. I don't have any stamps and gummage. Wait a minute. Hey, wait.
Do now.
Thank you very much. The world is over now. You can return to your bed.
Wow.
We're trying.
Well,
we're not trying hard enough.
Well, it's certainly
send us more money.
From where more
that
money.
How
money
much would you like?
$50,000, would you say that would do it?
Checks in the mail.
All right, thank you.
You're
thank
welcome.
You
yes, can next caller, please.
We'll put on the automatic Nelson.
We'll put
here,
the automatic
put
Bob Nelson
on.
On. Yes, okay.
Where's my thesaurus?
Ricky, Lucy.
Here, Bob, here's your hand. Put this part on.
Here we go. Now get Nelson.
Drive the station down Shattuck Avenue.
Never gonna stop. Ain't got no spare. We haven't got a spare for this program. We don't have a jack for this program. We don't even have a hydraulic foil for this program. We're just gonna drive until this program
goes and go and go.
Welcome.
Yes, I just wanted to say that Bob absolutely saved my life, and I'm so glad you're there. And I'm president of the Golden Lake Club at Camp Bay Radio. So I'm gonna write him a letter and tell him that you just aren't being treated like the good people you are. Goodbye.
Thanks a lot, Mom, for calling the show. And every
little squeaker.
Subgenie mind control gone out of control.
They handed me this jar and said my brain was in it, and then when the police came, they poured it down the sink.
He's been down to Bob's new subgenius. Well, what can we do for you, caller? Have you come to sing, entertain us, or do you have a burning question?
I got this weird thing, you see. You know how people often get reincarnated into this material plane no matter how hard they try?
Yeah, man.
I must have committed suicide 300 times, and I keep ending up in the same lifetime in a slightly different observational universe. And I have to talk to you guys because...
Yeah, man, that's really heavy.
Yeah, it's deeper than I can.
Wow, just lay it on us, man.
I keep being born on October 21st, 1952, and I end up having the same lifetime.
Oh, well, okay, your problem is you got a bad case of the 50s.
Oh, I've seen it.
That grassy knoll just went around the country shooting people.
There were 10 people there shooting it. Looked just like Kerry Thornley.
Got it, dead center.
Kerry Thornley!
Yes, he was the guest that scared everybody, even the other... Even the other stations were scared by Kerry Thornley.
So much.
Is he going to be at your convention?
Oh, yes.
Scary.
And here he is now, Gary Gabrofram and Little Bud Smith in the toxic shock absorber.
No, my name is Shower.
Here they are doing push-ups in the shower.
There's no water coming out of these showers, Doug. Just this funny smelling gas.
No, don't worry about
that's
the
P of D.
That's not water coming out of those
halt
showers.
The water effect.
That's church air.
Yeah, funny thing.
Really tough hombre.
Don't forget to use your drift meter.
Yes. The music is gone and the mucus is up. Oh, no.
Yes, hello.
We're really testing callers this morning. Good morning.
Good morning.
Are you man or woman enough to take the church?
Yes. As a matter of fact, we're planning the overthrow of the convention.
Ah, that's what we like to hear.
That's what we hear.
That's true. Yes,
kill Bob. Are there any secrets you can share with us at this time about how you'll be taking over the convention?
A bloodless coup.
By doing something so completely unpredictable, it will totally...
Oh, he's in the P-Dog, poop-dog school of tenderly convenience whipping the dead dog with silo
moves. I even wrote Dallas and said how predictable even the show has become.
It's James Joyce Nelson. He's doing a monologue, an internal... We can hear Nelson thinking. Listen.
Well, at least there's no babies. Let's get out of here before the babies still up the room with that poopy stuff.
Oh, stinking babies.
Changing diapers.
Well, if we walk out the door, the callers are going to call, and we can't let Nelson have a caller.
Right, you'll just have to stay there all night.
Yeah, well, only for another 6.5 hours, actually.
Meanwhile, they are yours to inspect in the privacy of your own home, shop, office, den for 20 years, or express permission already withdrawn by the Polk, McKinley, Harding, Dobbs, Coolidge, Mint, the only mint authorized stamp for application with its own seal.
Looks easy, doesn't it? But it won't come off.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, we were ripe the day we started this thing.
Yes, that's
why the
show
is ripe.
You're
starting
to rot.
Yeah,
I've been listening to Over the Edge, and I've had my callousness reinforced and verbalization therapy advanced to its highest possible stage.
Well, what portion of Over the Edge?
Really, seriously, it'll get you out of the 50s. Don't worry about it.
It's the enlightened quarter of the hour.
Yes.
How are you guys going to be on?
We're going to be on until they throw us out.
Or kill me! Or kill me!
Yes. There it went.
Yow. We wallow in our intellectual impotence.
Doug shorted the show out and spent the whole thing in one little 3-second buzz.
Yeah, sorry, I didn't mean to use up all of our tangible effects. Stay there until you fall asleep. When you fall asleep, that means we're off the air.
When you quit listening to us, we'll no longer be there.
You have to make the primordial matter of nature stand up and salute.
Oh, they were broken up. See, they'll get together, and that's why they'll cease to exist in April.
Okay.
We're talking about literally cease to exist.
Yeah, we're talking about flame out, you know? Ionization of most of the molecules involved.
No dirty vreedies.
Ball of fire in the studio.
So did I win the figurine or what?
Yes.
You're going to get a figurine that lights up, revolves, and dispenses free chowder.
Our miniature craftsmen have designed, cast, struck, etched, forged, and finished these authentic replications not available in any store, even on this radio station, before they're commissioned, literally without regard for any quality.
They come with their own adoption papers, and you can bring them into their own home.
You're kind of crazy.
But now, by special arrangement to the Postmaster General of Guam, this 72-piece commemorative plinth honoring you and the footprints of the great jewel thieves of the French Riviera mentioned earlier, each encased in its own watery silk caddy that revolves 360 degrees on genuine Swedish ball bearings, has been canceled. Sorry.
KSI のモードは
Yes, indeed.
There goes. Oh, it hurts, but then, we can carry it, caller. Okay, hold on.
The resulting confusion of all seismic signals will cause the simultaneous detonation of American warheads on their launch pad.
Hey, Doug.
Hey, Doug. Just come on in here. I've got three microphones in my own show. We don't even have to listen to Bob Nelson. No problem.
So, what are you guys going to do at this revival meeting? You're going to make fun of religion stuff, right?
We never make fun of religion.
Never make fun.
You
make
must understand
money.
We're making money off religion, but not fun of religion.
No fun.
We hope to erase the slack area in this part of the country.
Brutal and gruesome work.
And hopefully we'll...
These are called cribbage crotch figurines, and they're wanted in every home across America.
Cribbage crotch figurines?
That's right, young man, and you've won one.
Where do I get it?
Well, as soon as you sign out the Jewel form for the Lettuce Leaf Kids.
At Jewelco.
We have to put up with these guys because they know the right people to let us on the air. But you can trust me, Ivan Stang. Yes, you can trust me. I'm Dr. Ivan Stang.
Yes, well, you see, we have tapped to attack these songs with the full vim and vigor of all of those who are with us all the time.
I'll be at the revival, the great Subgenius revival on the 20th and the 21st at the Victoria Theater. So you can believe in me. I'm Ivan Stang. I never lie, and I'm always right.
It extends throughout the rules and...
Has to do with Gilligan's Island.